We're back.
And welcome back to Alabama State University Stadium in downtown Montgomery, Alabama, where we are almost ready to go. It is the Hornets' fourth game of this 2019 season. They are 1-2, and today they will face off against the Grambling State Tigers, a team that is 0-2 overall. But this is the first game in the SWAC for both of these teams, the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Chris Adams-Wall, J.C. Coleman, Rob Taylor down on the field, of course. Mel Marshall here, our producer in the booth, and then Jay Halsey, our engineer, back in studio. Thank you so much for tuning in. We hope you've had a great weekend so far, and we appreciate you taking the time to be with us. Grambling State has taken the field, and they are getting ready to kick from left to right to the Alabama State Hornets, who will receive the ball for the second straight week.
And that's a good thing. We got an opportunity now to set the tone early. You know, we're going to set the tone early if we get, you know, take this kickoff and hit Grambling in the mouth quick. Take care of the ball, some sustainable drives, and let's make this a long day for Grambling, and let's make the trip back to Louisiana just as long.
Garrett Urban is getting ready to kick off for Grambling State. Two men way back for the Hornets. That is Ezra Gray and Ja'Cory Merritt, and we are underway, and it's a pooch kick, an onside kick, and it's taken by number 34 for Alabama State. That's Devin Booker, who eludes a man and is finally brought down inside the 10. What a start for the Hornets in this game.
Yes, that's what we're going to need. We're going to need make them pay. Make them pay. Now, obviously, and that's some good coaching because Grambling thought they were going to be able to catch him off guard, but the Hornets came out prepared, and the pooch kick, we got it, and now we got first and goal. Not quite first and goal, but we're at the 12-yard line.
Well, the refs are still talking about it. It looked like he was brought down right around the 10-yard line, maybe a bit inside. And some trickery there early on from the kicker Garrett Urban and the Grambling State Tigers special teams. So they go with the pooch kick, and credit Devin Booker, who kept his cool. Not only did he secure it, but he had nothing but daylight in front of him. And he brings it all the way back to the 9. So a good return, and now we'll see if Alabama State can punch it in.
You know, you're talking about a helmet game. That was a helmet play.
There you go.
A good helmet play.
See, that's a good term. That's one we're going to be using
yes, sir.
All today. Kadarius Davis is in the backfield. He gives to Deron Bell, who is brought down at around the 10. Will be a gain of maybe nothing. And he was brought down by number 23. That's Keenan Fotentot, or Fotno, there we go.
Yeah, Fotno made a saving tackle there because he had actually had a lot of daylight on the outside.
So it's actually going to be a one-yard loss. And from the 10, it's Davis out of the shotgun again. Two wide receivers to his left, another one to his right, and Bell in the backfield. And now it looks like Davis is going to audible. Moving over to Davis's right is Bell. Davis gets the ball. It's the option. He'll pitch it to Bell, who cuts inside, and he's finally brought down. He almost got in, though, and he has a gain of about 8 down to the 2.
Shades of Kennesaw State, you know.
Right.
You know.
Yeah, we don't need to relive that.
Yeah, with the option.
Right.
Look real good. Good pitch.
Taking a page out of the Owls books with
yes,
that
sir.
One.
Yes, sir.
So it is 3rd down and 2 officially. Ball is on the 2. And the give is to Ja'Cory Merritt, who pushes and will not have enough. Looks like no gain there for the Hornets, and now it is decision time with it being 4th and 2.
You know, that's going to be close. I think they might have to measure on that one and look like we're sending in the big guns. No, actually, sending the kicker.
Yeah, it looks like it is going to be Hunter Hansen coming on to kick the field goal for Alabama State. So we'll see if he can give them the first points of the game. The holder is Anthony Craven. 13:07 remaining here in the first quarter. Here is the snap. Hold is down. Kick is on the way, and it is no good. Hooked left, and Grambling State is ecstatic about that miss.
Yeah, Grambling dodged the bullet that time, and you know, we got to capitalize on opportunities like that.
The good news is that Grambling State is now at their own 2. So Alabama State has them pinned all the way back, but That was a that's a kick that needs to be made by Hunter Hansen. A real chip shot there. He just hooked it wide left.
Well, actually, they're going to spot that at the 20.
Oh, okay. I got you.
Yeah, they're going to spot that at the 20. But it's a good move. Good move.
Yeah.
You know, good move. The Hornets look good, you know, starting out. Now we get a chance to go on defense and see what Grambling's bringing here.
And we'll see what Grambling State quarterback Jeremy Hickbottom has going on today. The 6'4", 200-pound redshirt junior out of Mobile, Alabama. He is out of the shotgun with a running back to his right. Looks like that is Kevin Dominique, but we are going to have a flag here. And it is a delay of game for the Tigers, so a lucky break there for Alabama State. That'll move him back five.
Yeah, we'll take it. And it's good to see the flags going the other way this time.
Right. It is Jakari Nichols in the backfield for Grambling State. First and 15. And Hickbottom will pass. He'll roll right. He'll take it himself. He's at the 30, 35, 40, cutting it up around midfield before finally being met by number 24, the safety for Alabama State, Joshua Hill. So a big gain there for Grambling State and a fresh set of downs as well onto the 45 their own.
Yeah, and Grambling, wide receivers did some good blocking downfield, you know, so everybody was all engaged. A lot of our players probably didn't think he was going to run because they actually had their backs turned and they might be reviewing targeting.
I see.
They might be reviewing targeting.
Yeah, and that would be against Joshua Hill if it is, in fact, a targeting call. I was trying to think, what could they be reviewing right now? But I think that's it.
Yeah. I think, actually, the quarterback, it looked like it was helmet-to-helmet contact. The quarterback was actually sliding, so we'll see.
A big gain there, though, for Jeremy Hickbottom. And let's go down to Rob Taylor.
Hey guys, look, he barely touched him. I mean, he didn't go full speed at him. He kind of let up as the quarterback was sliding. So I don't see how that could be targeting at it. Didn't appear to be like a solid helmet-to-helmet hit. He may have touched the helmet a little bit, but I'm not the official. We'll have to see what they have to say.
The officials are still talking about it. That's not a guy that Alabama State wants to lose. The senior strong safety at Pritchard, Alabama, Joshua Hill.
Yeah, and you know, it was that rule is a real tricky rule. It was very incidental contact. I mean, the quarterback was sliding and he went in to make the tackle, but it was just incidental, and that's why they're reviewing it. I think they're reviewing it to see whether it was malicious or was he able to avoid that.
Nevertheless, whatever the call is, it was a gain of 30 there on the ground for Jeremy Hickbottom, who also had 13 rushes for 58 yards against Louisiana Tech a couple of weeks ago in the Tigers' second game of the season, a 20-14 loss to those Bulldogs. Now we know that he can run it a little bit as well as pass it.
Yeah, he's another threat. That's a different threat we got to look out for.
Hickbottom also completed 26 out of 40 pass attempts for 239 yards and a touchdown against Louisiana Tech in that 20-14 loss.
And I noticed that the players, Alabama State players, are rallying around Hill, you know, patting him on the helmet, you know, and saying, you know, good play, trying to keep him up because, you know, you don't want to lose a guy. Here's the call. Wow. What a break.
Wow. So it is confirmed. It is targeting on Joshua Hill.
No, actually. Joshua Hill.
Yeah.
Right.
Wow. So he has been ejected from the game.
That is
unbelievable.
Yeah, you know.
That's the first offensive play for Grambling State and targeting called against the Alabama State safety.
And you know they didn't throw the flag. So it had to be seen from upstairs.
Right.
They didn't see it on the field. Wow, that's a tough break.
And so that's an additional 10-yard penalty for the Grambling State Tigers are against Alabama State. Hickbottom is out of the shotgun. He'll look to pass, and the ball is loose. It's still down. Alabama State falls on it, I think. And we'll see what happens. But it was number 27, Aaron Pope, who came out of nowhere and hit Hickbottom on the blind side. And it is Hornets ball. So unbelievable. What a swing of events.
What a play.
Alabama State loses one safety. Next play, the next safety swoops in and nails Hickbottom, jars the ball loose. And now Alabama State is back on offense again.
You know, that's what you do for your brother. When you want to pick your brother up, you know, you want to come in, you're going to make a good play for him because, you know, I got you. You know, I got you. And that's a good I got you play.
So Alabama State has the ball on their own 44-yard line. It's Davis out of the shotgun. He will give to Ezra Gray, who eludes a runner, then breaks left, has another hole, and goes across the 50 to the Grambling State 47. An 8-yard gain for Gray.
The key block was made by Kadarius Davis.
Yeah, I saw that.
The quarterback went down and made the key block.
He's a big guy. 6 feet, 184 out of Bessemer, Alabama is Davis, who is back out of the shotgun with Gray to his left. Here's the snap. Davis will pass. He looks right. Here comes the pass rush of Grambling State. Scrambling to his left now is Davis, and he's brought down on the wrong side of the 50. So that'll be a sack for the Tigers, and that'll bring up third down for the Hornets.
Davis.
Defensive linemen on this Grambling State defense. As JC says, they run a 3-4, and Davis had all kinds of time to find a man. Just led Knight a little too much with that last pass, and now back to punt is Anthony Craven for the Hornets. Here's the snap, and Craven will get off a good one, a booming punt all the way down to the 5, and it is fair caught there by Devonier Martin of Grambling State. And both teams are going to take a break. We'll take it with them. And when we come back, more Alabama State and Grambling State football. You're listening to Alabama State football on the Hornets Sports Network.
Run your purpose at Alabama State University. Choose from more than 60 degree programs from undergraduate courses in computer technology, education, theater arts, business, and the sciences to high-demand graduate degrees in physical therapy, social work, microbiology, and more. Our world-class faculty is ready to help you reach your goal. You'll also enjoy a vibrant campus life and Division I athletics. Come to our campus. Let us show you why it's always a great time to be a Hornet. For more information or to complete an application, visit us online at alasu.edu or 334-229-4291. Alabama State University. The time is now.
And welcome back to ASU Stadium in downtown Montgomery, Alabama. It is nothing-nothing with 10:17 to go here in the first quarter. Chris Adams-Wall, J.C. Coleman, Rob Taylor down on the field, Mel Marshall, our producer here in the booth, and then Jay Halsey, our engineer, back in studio. So it will be Grambling State ball. They'll take it at their own five. With their quarterback in there, that's Jeremy Hickbottom. He's out of the shotgun, and he'll hand it to the running back. That's number 23, Keelon Elder, who is wrapped up and brought down for no gain.
Yeah, the Hornets had good penetration that time, and just blew Grambling. Grambling has a huge offensive line, but we blew them right off the ball.
So the ball will now be on the six. So it was a gain of one, second and nine. Little extra punch there from Elder. The redshirt sophomore out of Dallas, Texas, who had five rushes for 26 yards 2 weeks ago against Louisiana Tech, as well as a lost fumble. And there's some movement there by number 80. That's Darrell James, the junior out of Tallahassee, Florida, wide receiver for the Tigers.
And yeah, keep an eye on number 79 for Grambling. You know, he's actually faced off against Christian and number 94. And he's trying to get in his stance real quick.
So that'll move him back half the distance. Ball is now on the three, and it is second and 12. Hickbottom all the way back into the end zone for this shotgun. And this is where Alabama State would have had Grambling State had they gone for it on fourth and goal in their first drive. Here's the snap. Hickbottom looking to his left. Now he'll take off with it again. And he's wrapped up and brought down again by the Alabama State defense. Nicely done there. That was number 34, Devin Booker, for the Hornets.
And, you know, Christian Clark, defensive line for Alabama State is drawing double coverage all over the field. So they're following him all over the field. So that's going to open up a lot of opportunities for these linebackers to clean it up.
And that was a tricky one there by Hickbottom because it looked like he tucked to run, but was still behind the line of scrimmage there, so could have thrown it. Doesn't matter against this Alabama State defense, though, so far. So it is third and 11. Ball on the four-yard line with 96 yards to go for the Tigers. Five wide. Here's the snap. Here's the throw, and it's a bad one by Hickbottom. And how about that Alabama State pass rush?
Man, that defense is – they are blowing Grambling offense off the ball. And that's good, so – the good thing about we're winning the battle up front. We're winning the battle up front now. If we could get some offense, you know, I mean, it's going to be a long day for Grambling.
That's what I think too. Momentum on the side of the Hornets right now, and the Tigers will be forced to punt. It'll be Miguel Mendez all the way back into the end zone, and let's see if Alabama State just brings the house right here. Might as well. Here's the snap. The punt is downfield. It's off, and it's taken at about the 37 by Alabama State, and that runner, number 29, that's Kobe Crabb, is going to take it all the way to the 20, so a terrific return, and the Hornets will have superb field position here with 8:32 remaining in the first quarter, still no score.
And that was a good punt return by the true freshman Kobe Crabb from Alexander City. That's one of those he's somewhat a River Region player. You know, we have 13 River Region players on our roster, so which is good for recruiting and good for fan base.
And he's a defensive back
by
trade, but showing very good hands on that one and a good return. So here we go. Alabama State back on offense. It's Davis, and the give is to Ja'Cory Merritt, who goes out to the right side before he is tackled just inside the 20. Maybe a gain of one or two, and that'll bring up second and eight for the Hornets.
Yeah, Alabama State is winning. They win in the trenches. Now I'm watching the trenches.
Trips right again. Davis will throw right, and it's complete to number 15, Jahad Booker. He'll have a gain of maybe two or so down to about the 15 or 14 yard line.
Jahad Booker's another one of those River Region players from Park Crossing here in Montgomery.
You were talking about him in the pregame show.
Yes, sir. Looking for big things from him.
Big catch there for him. Third and five now on the Grambling State 15 for the Hornets. Davis out of the shotgun again. Ezra Gray to his right, or Ja'Cory Merritt, rather. Davis scrambling, trying to get away from this Tiger pass rush. He's rolling left. He lofts it up to the back corner of the end zone, and that is into the seats. He just throws it away, and that'll bring up another fourth down. And now kicker Hunter Hansen will get a second shot at a field goal.
Hunter Hansen, Montgomery, Alabama. Another River Region player.
From Alabama Christian Academy.
Yes, sir.
That's where he went to high school. Now, he missed a chip shot earlier today. And this one is a bit deeper.
Yeah, I think he's going to redeem himself. We'll give him the opportunity to redeem yourself on this.
He'll kick it from the 22, so about a 32-yard field goal for Hansen. Ball is snapped, hold is down, kick is on the way, and this time it's good. And Alabama State takes a 3-0 lead here with 7:22 remaining in the first quarter. Well, you talked about the jitters, right, JC? Maybe that's what the problem was with Hunter Hansen at the beginning.
Yeah, now we got some points on the board now, and you know, so now let's see what we can do to get this ball back and make our way, make Grambling way a long way.
I like that. There you go.
Make Grambling way a long way.
So Hansen now 1-for-2 today, and we will send it to a quick break when we come back. 7:22 remaining here in the first quarter. You're listening to Alabama State Football on the Hornets Sports Network.
Look at all the cars. Lots of colored cars. Now there's a blue one. Isn't it pretty? Ooh, look how fast that red one's going. It's red like that stop sign. Like my jacket.
This is a 38-year-old man.
My jacket's not a car, is it? Is my jacket a car? My jacket is red, but it doesn't go fast.
He may sound a little strange to you and me.
Vroom. Vroom, vroom.
But to his 2-year-old son, who's interested in cars and colors, he makes perfect sense.
That's the sound cars make.
When you talk with your child, you build vocabulary, and learning starts long before school does. So follow their lead. Take simple everyday moments, like eating dinner,
come on back,
watching Jane. Cars go by, and turn them into learning moments.
Ooh, look, red car!
Yes! That is moving awfully fast.
Blue car!
Yes! The man in the red car is about to meet the man in the blue car. Get himself a pretty pink ticket.
Turn everyday moments into learning moments. For more tips, go to bornlearning.org. Brought to you by United Way and the Ad Council.
3-2-1.
And welcome back to ASU Stadium, where the Hornets are up 3-0 on the Grambling State Tigers. The Hornets have just kicked off. Do apologize for that. And I'm trying to get to breaks, man. That's been my biggest challenge today. The biggest challenge for Grambling State, though, has been the Alabama State defense.
Yeah, and that was pretty good coverage on that kick return that time by Alabama State.
So Grambling State has it at their own 23, and that's going to be a face mask. The give was to number 4, Kevin Dominique, the running back who took it up the middle. But this is going to be a definite face mask against the Hornets.
I think everybody in the stands saw that one. Everybody saw that. It was Christian Clark was fighting off that double team, and he just reached that big paw up there and just grabbed what he could grab. And
so that'll be an additional 15-yard penalty after the play, which will move the ball up to the Grambling State 45. So first and 10 for them. Jeremy Hickbottom out of the gun, and more movement. This time, I think, on the Tigers. And that's going to be on left guard David Moore, a 5-yard penalty for Grambling State.
And if you notice what Alabama State is doing up front on defense, they're moving the defensive linemen around, you know, and I think it's kind of confusing Grambling offensive line. They're shifting right before the snap.
Grambling State has 2 wideouts now. Make that 3 to the left side, 1 to the right. Hickbottom will continue to work out of the shotgun. He gets the snap. He fires it to number 14. That's Darquez Brunton, who drops the ball. It was right on his hands. A good pass by Hickbottom, but Another lucky break there for Alabama State. That'll bring up second and 15.
That's one of those plays when the coach, when you hear footsteps. You know, hear your footsteps coming, and I mean, but the Hornets are swarming this afternoon. The defense is really swarming.
Hickbottom continues out of the gun. He gets the ball. Now he'll run it, and he's brought down by a tackle there by number 90. That's Lucky Oyavi. And he was the one who finished him off, but it was looked like number 27, Aaron Pope, who made the initial hit.
Yes, and Alabama State sent their defensive back on a delayed blitz, and the quarterback actually ran right into the blitz.
So that'll bring up third down and 17 for the Tigers. It is 3-0 Alabama State, 6:13 to go in the first quarter. Here's the snap, and the pass is complete to number 10, Lyndon Rash, before he is wrapped up once again by this Alabama State secondary. That'll bring up fourth down as Rash was well shy of the first down, and Grambling State will be forced to punt.
Right, and that initial hit was made by Kenan Isaac. And, you know, Alabama State swarmed. The defensive backs are really doing some big things.
So back to punt now is Miguel Mendez. Tigers get the snap off, and Mendez will punt it all the way down to the 21, where it is fielded once again by number 29, Kobe Crabb. A fair catch there, and Alabama State gets the ball back. So we will go to a quick break. When we come back, there will still be 5 minutes and 32 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. It's still 3-0 Alabama State over Grambling State.
If there was ever a time to live united, it is now. Now is the time to speak with one voice, to build up, not tear down. It's time to join hands and live united against the problems that keep our communities from thriving. United Way fights for the health, education, and financial stability of every person in every community. Will you volunteer or donate now at unitedway.org?
Tune in to FM 90.7 WVAS for Promises of God with Reverend Cromwell Handy, pastor of Dexter Avenue King Memorial Baptist Church, every Sunday at 8:45 a.m. with Angier Johnson, the gospel messenger, on FM 90.7 WVAS, the sound of excellence.
And welcome back to ASU Stadium, where it is still 3-0 Hornets in this first game of SWAC play, Alabama State against Grambling State, and it is Alabama State football on their own 21. Four wide receivers for the Hornets and the quarterback, Kadarius Davis. One man in the backfield as well to his left. That looks like Ezra Gray. Man in motion, that's Ja'Cory Merritt, and the give is to Gray up the middle, who is swallowed by that front line there for the Tigers. That'll be a gain of maybe one or two, and that'll bring up second and 8.
You know, it's going to be interesting to see how we're going to use Big Jefferson. This defensive back is playing him man-to-man. There's no help over the top, and we give our quarterbacks time to throw. Look out.
Another man in motion, that's Merritt, moving to Davis's right. On his left, it's Gray. Still out of the shotgun is Davis, and now he'll change the play. Looking over to his left, onto the sideline. 4:54 remaining here in the first quarter. Here's the snap, and the give is to Gray again. He breaks one out to the right side, maybe for 3 or 4 before he's brought down by the Tigers, and that'll bring up third and 5 for the Hornets.
Third down's kind of manageable. Third and 5. Got a couple of options you can go with.
What's funny is during the pregame show, we talked about how this might be an offensive bonanza for both teams. So far, it's only 3-0 Alabama State. The defenses have both played big roles on both sides.
Yeah, we missed a couple of opportunities, but, you know, for the most part, they're playing pretty good.
Third and 5, it's Davis. He drops back. He fires over the middle and again overthrows Jahad Booker. And he had him, too. Had that one been on the money, that's a touchdown for Alabama State.
All day long. Yeah. See, we're actually getting open, When we're giving our quarterback time to throw, but he's a little jittery right now, so he's got to take his time and make more precise passes.
It looked like Davis had plenty of time as well. The Alabama State offensive line doing a nice job not only protecting him but creating that pocket for him to step up in. But Alabama State will have to punt one more time. So it'll be Anthony Craven back there to boot it down the field. He gets it off, and it's a good one. A spiraling kick all the way back to the 24, where it's taken by Grambling State, and this is going to be a big return down the left side before he's finally knocked out of bounds. That's number 25 again, Devin R. Martin. Big return for the Tigers, now in Hornets territory. And the Alabama State defense will have to keep this a 3-0 game.
Yeah, we looked like that was kind of busted coverage because we only had one guy who was the gunner downfield, and when he put a move on the gunner,
that was it.
Nothing but green grass, so I'm pretty sure there's going to be some discussion about that on the sideline.
So the return was all the way to midfield, so a gain of 26 for Devonir Martin. And back comes the Tigers offense led by the quarterback, Jeremy Hickbottom. He gets the snap and sends this one on the ground. And they won't get much. Another nice job done by that Alabama State defensive line.
Defensive line is playing real inspired. You know, ever since Joshua Hill left the game, they've been playing inspired.
So that was Jakari Nichols on that play. And it's Nichols again out to the left before he is speared and brought down. Looks like it will be a first down for Grambling State. That's a gain of 10. And a Tigers first down, and the Tigers will continue to go with the hurry-up offense. Here's the snap, and Hickbottom will keep it himself. He cuts it over to the left, dives forward, and has a gain of about 5 or 6.
Good for 7 yards, 2nd and 3.
That'll bring up 2nd and 3, and now we're seeing Grambling State do the hurry-up offense. And it looks like it's working so far against the Alabama State defense.
Yeah, they don't give us a chance to substitute.
It's Nichols again. And he will get maybe 1 or 2. He's shy of the first down. And I think that's going to bring up 3rd and 1. It is 3-0 Alabama State. 2 minutes and 36 seconds remaining here in the first quarter with the clock ticking.
And this is where the Hornets can bend but don't break.
Trips left for the Tigers. Hickbottom out of the shotgun again. He'll hand it off to Kevin Dominick, who powers forward and has another Tigers first down inside the 20. And they will continue to go with the hurry-up offense. Trips left again for the Tigers. And now the ref is going to bring it back a little bit. Still a first down, though, for Grambling State. Hickbottom will give once again to Dominick, who is brought down by that defensive line for the Hornets, a gain of maybe 3 or 4.
I think the Grambling coaching staff kind of saw something with this unit on defense, and they're not allowing Alabama State to substitute. So that's why they're going to hurry up. So they're not substituting, so we can't substitute.
So that'll bring up 2nd and 7. Two wide to the left, one to the right. It is Hickbottom. They'll keep it on the ground again, will the Tigers, and it is Dominick one more time as he plows forward just shy of the first down, though, a gain of 5, and that'll bring up 3rd and 2. Grambling State, though, knocking on the door.
And they're not giving Alabama State the chance, and that's a good timeout by Alabama State. That's a good timeout by Coach.
So Alabama State will take a timeout, and we will take it with them. You're listening to Alabama State Football on the Hornets Sports Network.
Looking to further your education? Take a look at the Harold Lloyd Murphy Graduate School here at Alabama State University. ASU graduate programs are designed to prepare students to be part of a vanguard of professionals through the 21st century.
All right, programs
to choose from. Doctoral programs, educational specialist programs, Master of Science programs, Master of Education programs, Master of Arts, Master of Rehabilitation Counseling, Master of Accountancy, and Master of Social Work. For more information about ASU's Graduate School, 334-229-4275 or visit alasu.edu/graduate school. Alabama State University, the time is now.
And welcome back to ASU Stadium here in downtown Montgomery, where the Alabama State Hornets have a 3-0 lead still on the Grambling State Tigers. Chris Adams-Wall, J.C. Coleman with you. Thanks so much for tuning in. Hornets about to have a big play here, and Grambling State as well, but both teams are currently in timeout. Alabama State took that to slow down this hurry-up offense for Grambling State. You mentioned, J.C., as soon as Christian Clark went out of the game, Grambling State wouldn't allow him to come back on because they just kept running and running and running. Right. Didn't give a chance for substitutions, but Clark back in there now for this big third and two.
Now he's back in, and you're going to see Grambling not try to run up the middle anymore because he was clogging up the middle. And that was a good observation by Grambling coach.
So we'll see what happens here. Jeremy Hickbottom out of the shotgun. Two wide receivers to his right. He'll keep it. He'll take it up the middle. And it looks like he will have enough for the first down. Brought down due to some whistles as number 75, William Waddle, he somersaults forward. I don't know if that was to distract the refs. I'm not sure.
He has to be a theater major. He has to be a theater major.
The redshirt junior out of Tallahassee, Florida. Some histrionics here with under a minute to go in the first quarter. It is a first and goal for the Tigers. Taking it to the left is Keelon Elder. He reaches for the end zone, and he's in. And Grambling State takes a 6-3 lead on the touchdown rush by Keelon Elder.
Well, Grambling found a little rhythm on that drive. You know, of course, with the big punt return, they had half a field to go. And they ran the hurry up a couple of times to give Alabama State a chance to substitute. So that's what we get.
Coming on to try to add the extra point is Garrett Urban, the kicker for the Tigers. Redshirt sophomore out of Houston. Here's the snap. Kick is on the way. And it is good. So Grambling State now up 7-3 on Alabama State after the touchdown run by Keelon Elder, the 5'9", 205-pound redshirt sophomore out of Dallas, Texas. Only had 26 yards rushing on 5 carries 2 weeks ago against Louisiana Tech and a lost fumble, but he puts it into the end zone here, and Grambling State takes their first lead.
Yeah, you know, I think most of Grambling's yards, we got 41 seconds left in the first quarter, but most of their yardage this whole first quarter has been on the ground. You know, a couple of big plays here and there. But I think all in all, we're looking pretty good.
Yeah, thankfully they're not running the triple option, though.
Exactly.
So this one a little bit easier to stop for the Alabama State defense.
Exactly, more traditional. But by the same token, they've got to stop us. But what we've got to do is we've got to take advantage of some of these breaks that we're getting. You know, our receivers are running downfield wide open, but our quarterbacks just been overshooting them. So we just got to take time and make some of these plays and take what they're giving us, and you know, and we can take control of this game.
And this is only going to be the second kickoff of the game for the Grambling State Tigers. The first time they did it was at the beginning of the game. It was a pooch kick to the right side, which was returned by Devin Booker for a good chunk, all the way down to about the 10. So we'll see if Grambling State does it again.
And it looked like we got the hands team out there. Look at all the receivers on the front line.
He kicks it deep this time, and it's fielded at about the 17 by Ja'Cory Merritt, who is brought down at the 25-yard line by the Grambling State special teams.
You know, it's a good game of chess going on because Alabama State had somewhat of a hands team out there, and Grambling knew they could not – they didn't have their regular blockers out there, so they decided to kick it deep, and that's what you got. We didn't have the blockers out there, but it's better safe than sorry because, you know, Grambling with that trickery, they could have tried it again.
So Alabama State will have the ball at their own 25. They're down 7-3 with 35 seconds to go in the first quarter. Kadarius Davis out there again, three wide to his right. Another wideout to his left. He fires left, and it's complete to Michael Jefferson. That's the first time that those two have hooked up today, and Jefferson gets about six.
And we're in a hurry right now, so maybe we can go down there. And, well, we don't. There's no real need to hurry right here.
And only the end of the first quarter.
Right.
13 seconds to go now. On the 7-yard completion, it is now to Jefferson. And Davis going back that way, this time to number one, Jeremiah Hickson. He makes the catch, and he's just shy of the first down. But that is going to take us to the end of the first quarter. Alabama State, though, a couple of completions for Kadarius Davis. And I'm not sure either team realized that was the end of the first quarter, but it is. So we'll send it to a break. You're listening to the Alabama State football on the Hornet Sports Network.
Introducing a breakthrough in time management technology. A whole new day of the week. It's called Someday. Ingenious. Perhaps someday you are going to go skydiving. Enter a hot dog eating contest. Maybe ride a mechanical bull. Now it's on the calendar. You may want to retire someday. Ready for that? You'll really want this. A My Social Security account. At socialsecurity.gov, you can estimate your future benefits, plan for your retirement, and how to save for it. If you already receive benefits, you can manage them online. Millions of people already have a My Social Security account. In fact, someone opens one about every 6 seconds. Get yours today, because someday is here at socialsecurity.gov.
Look, let's face it, there's a lot of music out there. So how do you cut through it all to find the best of the best? Hey, this is Kyle LaRue with your invitation to join me and the bass band Marcella Shepard. Each week we're counting down the top 10 jazz albums of the week, presenting a unique perspective on the music and the artists making it happen. We feature the best new music hot off the press as well. You'll find that and more when you join us here for the cool Jazz Countdown.
Saturdays at 8 p.m. on FM 90.7 WVAS, the sound of excellence.
Start of the second quarter back here at ASU Stadium in downtown Montgomery, Alabama, where the Hornets have the ball. It will be third and one on their own 34. They are down 7-3, though, to the Grambling State University Tigers. And let's go down to Rob Taylor on the sideline.
Okay, guys. Guys, one player that's missing, we haven't seen him since early in the first quarter, and that's Bell, Deron Bell. He's out. He hurt his shoulder. They got it iced down here on the sideline. You know, he's a speedster for the Hornets, but he got hurt early on, and I don't think he'll be back in the game.
Wow. So that's a huge loss for the Hornets. Deron Bell, the redshirt sophomore out of Tampa, Florida. Big play here, though, for the Hornets. Third and one. Davis will keep it himself, and he pushes forward, and it looks like he has enough for the first down, a gain of two.
Yeah, that's a huge loss for the Hornets if Bell can't come back into this game. But, of course, that gives Ja'Cory Merritt more opportunities to show you what he can do.
And, of course, they still have the senior Ezra Gray in there. He's to Davis's right, so a fresh set of downs for the Hornets. Now on their own 36. Here's the snap. Davis looks right, fires right, and it's dropped by number 8. Tyrek Allen. Looked like he threw it a little low and a little bit behind Allen, but Allen still appeared to get his paws on it.
Well, you know, as they say, as the coaches say, if you put your hands on, you're supposed to catch it.
Right.
You know, that we gotta bring that one in. It wasn't the best throw, but we gotta bring that one in.
And again, credit this Alabama State offensive line. They are giving Kadarius Davis all kinds of time to get these throws off. So that'll bring up 2nd and 10. Not even a minute into this second quarter. Grambling State up 7-3. Man in motion to the right. Davis looked right and then threw it to his left and threw that one a bit short off his back foot, attended for Michael Jefferson. So a good idea, just not all that well executed.
Davis kind of rushing his pass just a little bit. He's got to settle himself down and make better throws.
Michael Jefferson has caught a touchdown in each of his last three home games, including one last week in that 42-7 loss to Kennesaw State. So it'll be 3rd and 10 for the Hornets, trailing Grambling State University 7-3 here in the second quarter. 3rd and 10. Here's the snap. Dropping back is Davis. Here comes the pressure. He'll go to his left. He'll throw it, and he'll find Jefferson at the Grambling State 40, and he'll scamper out of bounds at about the 38. So there you go.
Right on cue.
Well done by Kadarius Davis. Maybe he needs to be rolling out to his right or left to get these accurate passes off.
Exactly.
That was a really nice play, and it's tough for a right-handed quarterback going that way to make a throw like that. So now Alabama State will go with the hurry up. It's slung out to the left by Davis, and that'll be a loss of a couple. But he does complete it again to Michael Jefferson.
Yeah, I think Grambling was looking for that one. You know, they was all over that play. But you're absolutely right, though. When he rolled out, you know, and Jefferson did a great job of not giving up on the play. You know, he did what receivers are taught to do, keep run downfield.
Almost a drag route there for him. So 2nd and 13 on the Grambling State 40. Davis, as is his wont, out of the shotgun. He gets the ball, looks right. He'll throw it deep down the sideline, and he overthrew his intended target. That was number 87, Ishmael Saleen. So that'll bring up 3rd and 13 now for Alabama State. In the first quarter, Davis was 3 for 6 for just 12 yards. He's accumulated more than that on this one drive. So 3rd down and 13, still the ball on the Grambling State 40. 7-3, Tigers lead the Hornets. Davis out of the gun. He drops back, throws it left, and he throws an interception. And it is to number 29, Joseph McWilliams, who has some blockers, and he's finally going to be brought down by Ja'Cory Merritt at the Alabama State 20-yard line. So I'm not sure what Kadarius Davis was looking at right there, but nobody really in that vicinity threw it right to McWilliams, and McWilliams made him pay.
Yeah, I think he was looking for Jefferson to run it out, but he ran it up. So when Jefferson actually didn't sit down on the route, so you don't know, I don't know who made the mistake.
Right.
But it was just miscommunication between the wide receiver and the quarterback, and it resulted in a turnover.
So Grambling State will get the ball back. Excellent field position. They'll be on the Alabama State 19. Quarterback Jeremy Hickbottom, back out there. He's out of the shotgun too. And the give is to number 23, Keelon Elder, who already has a touchdown today for the Tigers. He takes it to the right for a gain of about 5. So that'll bring up 2nd and 5 for Grambling State. This is a big possession here for the Alabama State defense.
Yeah, the defense got to be stopped right here.
Hickbottom out of the gun. They'll keep it on the ground again, and once again it's to Elder. He eluded a tackler or two, fell forward, got a gain of 4, and that'll bring up 3rd and 2. It is a gain of 3. Trips right. Hurry up again for Grambling State. Here's the snap, and the give once again is to Elder. And he'll plow forward, and does he have enough? It's going to be close.
I don't think he's got it. But I would not be surprised if Grambling didn't go for it if they didn't get it.
The ref on the left side here has signaled first down. I'm surprised they didn't measure on that play.
That was close. Yeah, he gave it to him.
They will give him the first down, though. So 1st and goal from the 8 for Grambling State. Trips right again, and movement up front.
No, timeout.
Or timeout. There we go.
Timeout. 1st and goal from the 8 for Grambling State.
So we will take this timeout with them. You're listening to Alabama State Football on the Hornet Sports Network.
I'm a firefighter.
A teacher.
I'm a farmer. I'm a barber.
A waitress. A mom.
We're all part of your community. Every day we move in and out of each other's busy lives.
It's easy to take for granted all the little moments that make up our everyday.
Some are good,
others not so much.
But that's life. It's when you experience a moment of uncertainty, something or someone's behavior that doesn't seem quite right.
These are the moments to take a pause.
Because if something doesn't feel right, it's probably not.
It's not about paranoia
or being afraid.
It's about standing up and protecting our communities.
One detail at a time.
Because a lot of little details can become a pattern.
We
trust our instincts.
Just like you should.
Because only you know what's not supposed to be in your everyday.
So protect your everyday.
If you see something suspicious, say something to local authorities.
3, 2, 1, you're back.
First and goal for Grambling State. They're up 7-3 here in the second quarter. Hickbottom looks to pass. Here comes the rush, and that's a sack. Alabama State.
Hickbottom sack.
And it looks like number 34, Devin Booker.
Once again. Yeah, that is Devin Booker.
Kobe Jones in as well with that play. And that'll move Grambling State back about 10 yards. So a huge play there. That'll bring up 2nd and 13 for the Tigers.
Another good defensive stand with Grambling trying to pass the ball.
Most of the field now in the shadows. Hickbottom still in the sunshine, though. He'll drop back into the shadows. Looking left, he hums it to the end zone, and it's dropped by number 10, Lyndon Rash, who tried to pull it in with a one-handed catch. It was a good pass, but
yeah,
those one-handed grabs are tough.
He made a great effort. Great effort. But we got to give props to this defense, because they actually came in and we're actually third down now. We got to do it one more time. Got to do it one more time.
And there seems to be some confusion about where the ball should be, maybe. I have no idea. The refs are kind of huddling around it.
Interesting. Grambling coach is giving him an earful over there.
Yeah, he is. That's head coach Broderick Fobbs. Fobbs, who played at Grambling State back in the day. His dad also played at Grambling State under the legendary Eddie Robinson.
Oh, wow. Looks like he's trying to draw a flag.
But there is no flag. So this is going to bring up 3rd and goal. From the 19-yard line. Big play for both teams here with Grambling State up 7-3. Hickbottom will pass. He has some time. Now here comes the pass rush. He's flanked to the left, and he'll be brought down. He'll still throw it to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
And we got a illegal block in the back and a holding call, but he might not give us a holding, but that penalty is going to be on Grambling.
And where would that move them, though? Maybe out of field goal range.
Yes, take it.
But if you take it, then it's 3rd and goal again, correct?
Yes,
so they'll get another shot at it, but
third,
at least that wipes the field goal, right?
Right. Got the holding.
So that'll be on DeMondre Jacobs.
And he actually tackled. He tackled the defensive guy.
Credit Aaron Pope, though, who is having a terrific game. We know Joshua Hill, the other safety in the Alabama State defense, was ejected from the game on the very first play from scrimmage for the Grambling State offense. Mm-hmm. He was ejected for targeting, but Pope was in there, and he was the one who brought down Hickbottom trying to get off that throw. So that will move the Tigers back to their to the 29. That'll bring up 3rd and goal from the 29. Three receivers on the left, one on the right. Here's the snap. Hickbottom will keep it himself. His goal here is just to get him into field goal range, and another flag flies onto the ground as Hickbottom's brought out at around the 16.
It's going to be another holding call, so I take the penalty.
And just keep on moving them back.
Keep moving them back. Keep moving them back. You know, Grambling traditionally has some of the largest offensive linemen in the SWAC, but they always have the slowest. So that's why when their quarterbacks start to scramble, then what these big guys do, they're slow, so they start grabbing.
Gotcha. So this is about to be one of the longest 3rd and goals you will ever see. The ball is on the 37-yard line, and it's 3rd and goal from there for the Tigers. Out of the shotgun is Hickbottom. He'll fling it out to the left. It's caught there by number 14, Darkeys Brunton. He muscles his way to the 30 before he's finally brought down, and now we'll see what the Tigers decide. I imagine they'll try to kick it. Well, let's Garrett Urban is coming out onto the field. This is going to be a deep field goal, though, for the right
They've got
kicker.
They've got if they don't have Garrett Urban premium, you don't think they look out for the fake or whatever. They're trying to get Alabama State to jump offside or whatever. But I don't think he's going to make this field goal.
This is going to be a 47-yard attempt for Garrett Urban, the redshirt sophomore out of Houston, Texas. Here's the snap. Hold is down. Kick is up. It's on the way. And it is no good. It was wide right. It had the distance, but not the accuracy. And Alabama State will take over after a really strong defensive stand.
A great defensive stand. Matter of fact,
let's go down to Rob Taylor.
Hey, guys, you know, it's funny. Every time there was a flag thrown on the field, the head line judge would come over to coach and say, "Coach, what do you want to do? You want to take them back?" And coach would always say, "Take them back." Each time, the head line judge would make the call before coach could even get it out. Take them back. Take them back. And it was a good choice by Coach Ely to push the Grambling Tigers back. Now we can see what this ASU offense can do. We need to get that ball downfield and get some points, more points, on the board.
Thanks, Rob. 10:05 remaining now in the second quarter. Alabama State will have the ball at their own 30. It's Kadarius Davis out of the gun, and he'll hand it off to Ezra Gray, who gets maybe a yard, and that'll bring up second down.
You know, when KD ran that RPO that time, he may have handed the ball off a little early because he actually had he pulled that, he had nothing but daylight.
Both of these quarterbacks working almost exclusively out of the shotgun today, and this play is no different. One running back, it is Gray, who is to Davis's right, and a pair of wideouts to Davis's left and right. Gray now moves behind Davis, and the give is to Gray. He'll break it out to the right, and he'll lose at least one, maybe two.
Our defensive line at that time shot the gap. You know, our offensive line shift to the right, and he just shot right through the gap and beat the play.
Michael Jefferson is out there, far side of the field on the left. Also out there is Tyrick Allen on the left. Jeremiah Hickson as well. So third and 11 for the Hornets with 9 to go before halftime. Here's the snap. Davis feels the pressure. He steps up in the pocket, whips it over the middle to Hickson, who makes the catch and is then tackled at about the 45. That's a first down for the Hornets and one of the best passes that we've seen so far today from Davis.
He caught Grambling in a blitz, and the wide receiver sat right down where the blitzing linebacker ran from.
It's one of the first times today that we've seen Davis step up in the pocket as well, and it paid major dividends. So first and 10 on the Alabama State 46. Davis gets the shotgun. He'll take off, and he'll slide forward to about midfield. A gain of maybe 4 for the Hornets. That'll bring up second down and 6.
Good for 4 yards. Second and 6.
And Davis can run a little bit.
Yeah, he's got good agility.
Smart decision there. Hey, you gain 4 yards every time. You're going to score a lot of touchdowns.
Exactly.
Three wideouts to the left, one to the right. 7-3 Grambling State here in the second quarter with just under 8 minutes to go. It's the option, and it's out to number 21, Ja'Cory Merritt. He gets maybe one. And they're now into Tiger territory are the Hornets, but that'll bring up third down and 7.
You know, I'm still not impressed with Grambling's ability to stop our passing game because our receivers are getting open. We just got to hit them. And here's another opportunity to show that.
And you got to believe that they will be passing on this play. Three wide receivers on the left, one on the right. In the backfield is Ja'Cory Merritt. And it is Davis. He'll throw it over the middle, and it's complete again to Jeremiah Hickson for another Hornet first down. Good slant route there run by Hickson, the sophomore out of Spanish Fort, Alabama.
And that particular play is open all day. It's open all day. And those are the same passes that he was missing earlier. He was missing on.
Yeah, I think once they get into halftime, it's going to be pass, pass, pass in the second half because that has been there all day, as you said, JC. So first and 10 on the Grambling State 41. Here's the handoff, and going nowhere is the running back, Ja'Cory Merritt. He maybe lost one as well.
And, you know, with Bell out, you know, that takes an element of the game. That changes the game a lot because Bell is that quick hitter. You know, Merritt has a 4.24, but he's not quick as Bell. But he's fast, but he's not as quick.
Merritt is a true freshman, too, out of Montgomery, Alabama, just down the road. Shotgun again for Davis. He'll look right. He'll fire right. He has a man, and it's caught. And it's number 87, Ismail Saleem, inside the five. A huge play there, and what a throw by Kadarius Davis. That's what we were looking for in the first quarter, but Davis starting to heat up.
Definitely.
So first and goal from the four. What an over-the-shoulder catch made by Ismail Saleem, the redshirt senior out of Montgomery, Alabama, as well.
Timeout, Grambling.
So Grambling State will take a timeout, and we'll take it with them. You're listening to the Alabama State football team on the Hornet Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Ryan Seacrest for RAD. Over 300 people in this country are killed every week by a drunk driver. That's the equivalent of 2 747 plane crashes every single week. And the problem isn't going away unless we all do our part to stop it. So if you see someone who's about to drive after drinking, get the keys. Don't leave it up to anyone else. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
A public service announcement brought to you by RAD, the National Association of Broadcasters, and the Ad Council.
In the aftermath of a disaster, victims want to get their lives back in order as soon as possible. But if your home has been damaged, the last thing you want is someone taking advantage of you. Contractors who show up right after a storm may be fraudsters, out to make a quick buck off of your insurance claim. They'll promise anything as long as they can get you to sign a contract and hand over a payment. Know who you're dealing with, and remember, if you didn't request it, reject it. To report fraud, call us at 1-800-TELL-NICB. A public service message from the National Insurance Crime Bureau.
Broadcasting from the campus of Alabama State University, this is FM 90.7 WBASHD, Montgomery, Alabama.
3, 2, 1, you're back.
And welcome back to ASU Stadium. The Hornets are knocking on the door. They have the ball at the Grambling State 4. They trail 7-3 with 5:49 to go here in the second quarter. It's Davis from the shotgun. The give is to Merritt. Up the middle, and he's in for a touchdown. Ja'Cory Merritt has put the Hornets back on top, and now they lead the Tigers 9-7 here in the second quarter.
Yeah, good run by the true freshman when he went hit the hole and he kept his feet moving. That's what you're taught. And as a good running back, you can't teach that. You know, that's instinct. You know, that's why I like Ja'Cory Merritt.
Right up the gut. And he's a true freshman well.
You've got a long time to do that at Alabama State.
Big touchdown for the Hornets. And now Hunter Hansen will come on to tack on the extra point. Anthony Craven, the holder. Here's the snap. Kick is on the way, and it is good. So Alabama State is up 10-7, and let's go down to Rob.
Ismail Saleem, like the forgotten receiver. Everybody's been talking about Michael Jefferson and Hickson, but Ismail, did you see that move? He put on the Grambling defender. I mean, it's what they call it. He juked him. I mean, he was in and out. A beautiful pass by Davis. Great job by the Hornets.
And that was the longest pass that we've seen so far today for either team. A 38-yard reception by Ismail Saleem, the redshirt senior out of Montgomery. And what a play, and that's what led to the 4-yard touchdown run by Ja'Cory Merritt. And all of a sudden, Alabama State back on top. We're going to go to a quick break, though. When we come back, there will still be 5:44 remaining in the game. Alabama State now on top. You're listening to Alabama State Football on the Hornet Sports Network.
No time now. I'm cleaning the fish tank.
You can always come up with an excuse for not visiting longtermcare.gov.
Gotta go. Yoga class starts in 10.
Oh, I forgot. Game night.
Perfectly understandable, since going to longtermcare.gov means you actually acknowledge that one day you will be, dare we say it, old.
Hey, do you see any crow's feet on this face? I don't.
And 70% of
come back, Jay, come back.
Need some form of long-term care services as they age. If you're 50-plus, time to create your strategy for aging so you can stay in charge.
Well, you know, 50 is the new 30.
Sure.
3, 2, 1, you're back.
So Alabama State now in the driver's seat once again. They were up 3-0 early. They fell behind 7-3. But Ja'Cory Merritt's 4-yard touchdown run has put them back on top 10-7, JC.
And now we get a chance to see what coach has worked on the special teams. You know, we've given up some big plays on kick returns. So this is our first opportunity to see our kick return team today, see what they worked on.
Hunter Hansen will kick it down the right side. It takes a bounce of the 20 before it's finally fielded by number 27 for the Grambling State Tigers before going out of bounds, and that was Justin Richard. And it's a good thing he was over there, too. That ball hung up there for a long time. If he's not down there, Alabama State hops on that. It's their ball.
And, you know, that was a heads-up play by number 27 because the receiver on this side of the ball actually didn't – like he was just going to sit there and let it bounce. You know, that's just like an onside kick at Alabama State recovery.
It's an excellent kick by Hunter Hansen. So here we go, 5:42 remaining here in the second quarter, 10-7 Alabama State. And it is the quarterback, Jeremy Hickbottom, out of Mobile, Alabama, out of the shotgun as well. He gets the snap. He'll throw it over the middle, and it's complete to number 10, Lyndon Rash, who is met by a couple of defensive backs there for Alabama State.
He called it incomplete.
And he called it an incomplete pass. Wow. Sure looked like he hung on, but Rash can be forgiven for not making that catch. Man, that looked like it hurt right in the back. It was right on the numbers, too. But a couple of the safeties there for Alabama State breaking it up. So second and 10 on the Grambling State 22. Here's Hickbottom again. Has some time. Looks right. Fires right. And it's complete.
Great play.
To number one, Donald Johnson Jr., who is out of bounds at the 26, a gain of 4 for Grambling State. So that'll bring up 3rd and 6, 5:24 remaining now in the second quarter, 10-7 Alabama State as they make a couple of substitutions.
And Jeffrey Hill made an excellent play that time. He was on an island, and it was just him and the receiver. Great play, great defense stop.
So a big play here for the Hornet defense. Hickbottom still out of the gun. He drops back, fires over the middle, and this time Rash will hang on. He has the first down, and it's a gain of about 12.
I just love the way the coaches are playing chess. Now, Grambling's coming out this time, this series. They hadn't run the ball at all.
Right.
Just pass. And it's going to be interesting to see.
I don't think we've seen either quarterback take a snap under center either as we have flags.
Well, we only took one. We did the quarterback sneak on his end.
That's it.
Yeah,
I think that's about it, though. Yeah,
that's about it.
So I think we're going to have a timeout for Grambling State. It is 10-7, and we will send this to a break. Alabama State in front. You're listening to Alabama State Football on the Hornet Sports Network.
Message from the American Migraine Foundation.
It's an absolute nightmare. I was terrified. It's like your head's going to explode.
Migraine is a disabling disease.
Just all of a sudden couldn't see. Migraine has ruined my life. Absolutely terrifying.
There's pain that does not stop.
It's a throbbing, pulsing, banging, hammering feeling in your head.
36 million Americans suffer.
I started getting migraines around 5 years old.
Just takes over everything.
I feel trapped by migraine.
It hurts like my head's going to like fall off.
And the whole world around you stops.
My world has gotten small.
You feel like the world's closing in on you. There's nothing you can do.
I had spent a year housebound.
It's like you're trapped in your head. There's no escaping it. You can't leave your body.
Don't suffer alone. Make your move against migraine. Visit AmericanMigraineFoundation.org to find help, learn more, and get connected.
3, 2, 1, you're back.
So here we go, 4:38 remaining here in the second quarter. First and 10 for Grambling State. It's Jeremy Hickbottom, the quarterback. He has all kinds of time, and he's flushed out of the pocket. He'll take off down the right side all the way down to the 30, before he dips out of bounds, and that is a huge gain there for the Tigers. Now into Hornets territory.
Higginbottom showed showed a little speed, and he showed some strength that time. He great stiff arm.
That's all the way down to the 30-yard line with 4:15 to go here before halftime. Trips right for the Tigers. Here's the snap. The give is to number 44, Jakari Nichols. He'll turn it out to the left before he's pushed out of bounds at about the 20. That's going to be close to a first down for the Tigers. Another one, and it is a first down.
Nichols at left end for 10 yards.
So we got a chance to substitute and get our big guys back up front now.
And you do not want Grambling State to score right before the half. They get the ball when the third quarter begins. It's up the middle to Nichols this time. And he has a gain of about 5. So that'll bring up 2nd and 5 and late flags on the play.
Too many men on the field.
The ref doing some quick counting there.
Yeah, we were trying to get our big guys. Trying to get the big guys on the field, and somebody got caught, you know, stuck out there.
So we're going to repeat first down.
First and 5.
And yeah, it'll be 1st and 5 from the 15. 10-7 Alabama State with 3:49 to go here in the second quarter. It's Higginbottom who rolls right, fires right, has a man who eludes a tackler, and he's inside the 5. That was number 13, Quinton Geis, on the reception. And that's another first down for Grambling State. And now it'll be 1st and goal inside the 5-yard line. They'll have it on the 3. Trips right. It is Higginbottom. And the give is to Nichols, who's wrapped up and brought down for a gain of none. So that'll bring up 2nd and goal with 3:15 to go now here in the second quarter.
Grambling is overloading one side, and they're running the quarterback to the opposite side from the overload. So the quarterback has one man to beat.
So Kevin Dominique will check into the game now. He's the running back in this trips right formation for the Grambling State Tigers.
And watch, they run it back this way.
A lot of space on that left side. The give is to Dominique. He stumbles a moment, and the Alabama State defensive line shuts down the running game again. 3rd and goal now.
Christian Clark.
And thankfully, he's in the game now.
Yes,
and can stay in the game.
Yes, sir. He can plug that hole.
And now Dominique will get a breather, heading for the sideline, back into the game. Keelon Elder, who has the Tigers' lone touchdown today. 10-7 with 2:20 to go here in the second quarter. 3rd and goal for Grambling State. Here's the snap. And Higginbottom will keep it, and he's brought down at the 4-yard line, a loss of 1, and that'll bring up 4th and goal.
Christian Clark
again. And Devin Booker in there as well. Good play by the Alabama State defense. Number 48, Trevor Goodrum, in on that gang tackle as well. So now Grambling State will bring out their kicker. That's Garrett Urban, who is 1-for-1 on extra points today, but has not, well, just attempted that one field goal, 0-for-1 there, trying to tie the game here on this kick. It's up, and it's good. So we are now tied at 10, and let's go down to Rob Taylor.
All right, guys, we're going to see what Coach Ely has to say at the half. All tied up, and the Hornets put some more points on the board before the clock ticks 0 before the half. But great hold, great job by the defensive unit. Coach Pearson, he's always halfway out there on the field screaming at his guys, and they've been doing a pretty good job so far.
Yeah, when you consider that they had the ball, Grambling State, on the Hornets' 3-yard line, 1st and goal from the 3, and did not score a touchdown. I mean, well done by the Alabama State defense to hold Grambling State to just the field goal.
Not bad at all. With a minute and 33 seconds left, we got a good game. You know, it's 10-10. You know, you can't ask for anything better. You know, with all the miscues that we've had and some of the missed passes, to go into, if we go into halftime at halftime tied at 10-10, we're in good shape.
And the SWAC is definitely back in full swing. This is a good one. 10-10 in the second quarter with a minute and 33 seconds left. And we'll see if Alabama State can make something happen and with this little time left.
And let's see if Grambling will kick the ball off.
Yeah.
You know, that's...
And we'll see where Garrett Urban tries to put it.
Right.
He's ready to go. And the kickoff is down to the left side and out of bounds. Alabama State will take that every day and twice on Sunday.
Yes, sir. We'll take that one at the 35. You know, I think maybe that's why he tried the trickery. He's not a very good kicker on the kickoff.
Might have been an accidental trickery.
Yeah, exactly.
You never know.
Yeah.
Had us fooled.
Yeah.
On that pooch kick to begin the game. He may have tried it again there, but not so successful this time around. And Alabama State will get the ball on their own 35 on the left hash mark. And Kadarius Davis going back out there with his running back, Ezra Gray, to his right.
We'll see if we're going to be content with 10 points, or will Coach try to put some more points on the board before halftime.
Because remember, Grambling State gets the ball after halftime. Davis will pass. He steps up in the pocket, gets tripped up, and tumbles down, and that'll be a sack for the Grambling State defense. And that was number 8, Anthony Mullins, the redshirt senior out of Aliceville, Alabama. And now we'll see if Alabama State is a bit more cautious the rest of the way, because if they complete that first pass, that may be a go, 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 but now it's looking like they're going to slow things down and go into halftime at 10-10.
Yeah, take your time now, and if you get a big hit on the next play, then you try to speed it up again, but, you know, no harm, no foul. You know, coach is probably content to go in the locker room with a 10-10 tie.
About 45 seconds left. Davis will throw left, and it's complete to Jeremiah Hickson.
For a loss.
But it's complete for a loss, correct. And now we'll see what Grambling State does.
Yeah, Grambling might call a timeout.
Good for 2 yards, 3rd and 12.
But I'm pretty sure Grambling is probably content with going in at halftime. 10-10.
I think they probably are. But they will take a timeout. And we'll take it with them. You're listening to Alabama State Football on the Hornet Sports Network.
Big investment. If you live in a condominium or homeowners association, decisions by your board and community manager affect you. Is your board knowledgeable? Is your manager trained? Is your investment protected? CAI, Community Associations Institute, can give you the tools to protect your home and community. CAI is a nonprofit organization with resources for your board, community managers, and free information for homeowners like you. CAI at responsiblecommunities.com.
Listen and imagine. It takes 5 seconds to send a text, and for those 5 seconds, you're driving blind. Life is worth more than a text. Stay alive. Don't text and drive.
Visit StopTextStopWrecks.org, a message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, Noise, and the Ad Council.
2-1, you're back. So after a Grambling State timeout, Alabama State will have the ball here on 3rd and 12. It is Davis over the middle, and it's almost complete to number 15, Jahad Booker. It was right on the hands, but some Grambling State defenders in the area there, and that will bring up 4th down with 34 seconds to go here in the first half.
And this is going to be very interesting with 34 seconds on the clock. If we get a good punt here, you know, Grambling would probably want to sit on it, but if they get a pretty good return, you know, look for a quick timeout, and they'll try to put something on the board, maybe try another field goal before halftime.
And remember, Craven had one blocked last week against Kennesaw State. So he'll need good protection here. It's a low snap, but Craven handles it and boots it down the field. It takes a terrific bounce. And where is this one going to end up? Inside the 15 before it's finally touched by the Alabama State special teams. What a punt by Anthony Craven. Great just kick. What the doctor ordered.
Just what the doctor ordered. Flip the field now. So now Grambling has very limited options now. So you probably see them come out with one quick hitter, maybe one try to get it over the middle or catch one of these one-on-one on the outside. They might try that if they're successful. But if it fails, look for Grambling to just pack it in and go in and take these 21 seconds on in the locker room with a 10-10 tie.
And as they've done for all of this game, they'll be out of the shotgun. That's their quarterback, Jeremy Hickbottom, who will pass, and it's just a swing pass out to the left, and it is complete, and it looks like that might do it for the first half. It was complete to number 9, Richardson, who was wearing a different number on the road. That's Raylan Richardson, who is typically number 18, but that will do it for the first half. And before we go to half, let's send it down to Rob Taylor.
All right, guys, we're going to let Coach Ely make his way down. He usually try to get all his players off the field before he makes his way into the locker room. And we're trying to find Coach right now. And we see him making his way now, talking with one of the players, talking with the quarterback, Kadarius Davis. We'll get with him. All right, Coach, all tied up at the half. What do you think of the play of the Hornets?
Man, we just got to clean up a couple of mistakes. I thought we should be up. Didn't capitalize on the first drive. Defense been doing a good job of making things happen. Offense now just need to settle down and make our throws and come out and play a good half of football.
Thanks a lot, Coach. All right, that's Coach Donahue. Ely said he got to settle down. You guys mentioned earlier that maybe it was just some jitters. So Coach said he got to settle down and play a good second half of football, guys.
All right, thanks, Rob. Yeah, it should be a good one. The beginning of the SWAC season has been even better than promised. It's an even score so far, 10-10 between Alabama State and Grambling State. And that will take us to halftime, JC.
Yeah, and, Coach, I know Coach is going to be upset when he go in at halftime because we could be up another two scores on Grambling. But all in all, everything is looking pretty good. I figure we could clean up those few mistakes and capitalize on some of those drop passes. We'd be able to take this victory on in.
Been a great game, though, so far. 10-10 between Alabama State and Grambling State. We'll send it back to the studio, and then we'll pick it up in about 20 minutes from now for the start of the third quarter. Back to you guys.
Find your purpose at Alabama State University. Choose from more than 60 degree programs from undergraduate courses in computer technology, education, theater arts.
do our morning laps on bike ride through Saturday afternoon.
Robbie G.
We will walk our dogs around the block. We will pass up the elevator and proudly.
Are you there, Rob?
Because arthritis can't beat us if we beat it first. In the fight against arthritis, you need a weapon. What's yours? To learn more, visit us at fightarthritispain.org. This message brought to you by the Arthritis Foundation and the Ad Council.
3, 2, 1, you're back.
And welcome back to ASU Stadium, where it is 10-10 between Alabama State and Grambling State, with 13:06 remaining in the third quarter. Joseph McWilliams, safety for Grambling State, was just helped off the field after an injury. So it will be a big 4th and 2 for the Hornets, who will go for it. Davis out of the shotgun. Ezra Gray to his right. And the pass is to the right, and that is complete to Larry Brown. But he's going to be short of the first down, and that's a turnover on downs for the Hornets. And now the Tigers will take over on offense.
Yeah, that was a real good defensive play by Grambling that time. And then, you know, they just lost their the defensive back. And, you know, that's already a depleted defense. And we couldn't take advantage of that. So, good stop by Grambling. You got to give credit where credit is due.
Very good stop. That's Brown's first catch of the evening. But now it's Grambling State ball on their own 31 with 13 minutes flat remaining here in the third quarter. Back to work goes Jeremy Hickbottom, the quarterback. Trips right. Another receiver to the left. He'll throw it right. It's complete to Donald Johnson Jr., who does a little shimmy and then falls forward for a couple. Looks like a gain of maybe 5 or 6 for Grambling State, and that'll bring up 2nd and 4.
Grambling's coming out spreading the offense now, trying to get some one-on-one matchups this time.
Hickbottom out of the gun, and all kinds of daylight for Jakari Nichols. All the way to the 20, to the 10, and he's finally brought down by number 22, Urshad Davis of the Hornets. But now it'll be 1st and goal for Grambling State after a big gain on the ground for the Tigers.
And that's what happened when the play before that, they set that play up because they spread everybody out, and the linebackers had to get in pass coverage that time. So when you break through the line, then there's nobody there.
So 1st and goal, and now it's a handoff to Keelon Elder, who's wrapped up for a 3-yard loss. That'll bring up 2nd and goal from the 10.
My high school coach used to say he doesn't have to score.
That was a 55-yard run, though, by Jakari Nichols.
And great save by number 22 to run him down. Walked him down.
That's the first guy who touched him on that play. Hickbottom out of the gun. 3 wide receivers to the right. He'll look right. He'll fling it right. And it is caught at the 3-yard line before Donald Johnson Jr. goes out of bounds with a reception. So that'll bring up 3rd and goal from the 3.
And he was wide open that time. Somebody missed assignment on that one.
And remember, you only have to get 1 foot down in college. That's exactly what Johnson did. Big play here, though, for the Hornets. 10-10, 3rd and goal from the 3, and a whistle. And it looks like that'll be a timeout. Charge to Grambling State. And do we want to try to send it back down to Rob?
Well, I'm here.
Okay. Hey, all right. Technology, right?
Welcome back, second half.
Hey, guys. I don't know what happened the first time around, but those kind of things
happen. We missed you, man.
Hey, the Hornets, this is not the way to start the second half, you know, allowing Grambling to get that big open like that and a big run. So we got the defense got to show up right here and stop the Grambling Tigers. We'll see if they can do just that. Wanted to correct some things, as Coach said, that you mentioned, JC, correct some things in the second half. Well, I don't know. We got to do better than this.
Yeah, I do think that if we get out of this with just 3 points, it's pretty good, you know. You don't want to give up a touchdown right here. It's 3rd down and 3 yards to go. If we could just come out of this with 3 points, we won't be so bad.
This is the exact same spot where Grambling State was on their previous possession, and Alabama State stopped them and held them to a field goal. Can they do it again? It's Hickbottom. He'll keep it himself, and he's finally tackled, and he will not get in, and that'll bring up 4th down.
Great play by the defensive end to stay at home. You know, he said he didn't bite on the pitch. He stayed home, and Hickbottom had no choice. You know, He couldn't beat him.
Nicely done by the Alabama State linebackers there.
Mm-hmm.
Hickbottom has been a problem for them today, but they take care of business here. And now Urban is back out there to try to put the Tigers back on top. 10-10 with 11 minutes to go here in the third quarter. The holder is Miguel Mendez. Here's the snap. Kick is on the way, and it is good. So Grambling State back out in front at 13-10 now with 10:49 remaining here in the third quarter.
Not so bad. It's not so bad. You know, you give up 3 points. You know, they got the ball first. You only gave up 3 points, so we got to go out and take care of the ball and do a better job.
And give credit to Urshad Davis for bringing down Jakari Nichols on that 55-yard scamper, which could have very easily gone for a touchdown.
And that could very well be the player of the game, depending on how this game turned out.
So we will go to a quick break. You're listening to Alabama State Football on the Hornet Sports Network.
If there was ever a time to live united, it is now. Now is the time to speak with one voice, to build up, not tear down. It's time to join hands and live united against the problems that keep our communities from thriving. United Way fights for the health, education, and financial stability of every person in every community. Will you volunteer or donate now at unitedway.org?
Hey, hon, do me a favor and hold the ladder for me.
I have a better idea. Let's just call somebody to clean the gutters.
To scoop out a few leaves? Come on, I'll be down in a heartbeat.
No!
Using a ladder might seem easy. Misusing one is even easier. For tips on ladder safety, visit orthoinfo.org, a public service message from the American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons, who want to keep your bones safe, strong, and well-connected.
And welcome back to ASU Stadium, where Grambling State has just taken a 13-10 lead thanks to a short field goal made by Garrett Urban, Tigers kicker. And we'll see what this penalty is. We are getting some word from College Station that the Auburn Tigers have defeated the Texas A&M Aggies 28-20. So a big win for the Tigers today, JC.
Yeah, it's going to be good for Central Alabama.
And, of course, Alabama was playing me and you earlier today, a win for them over Southern Miss. And Alabama State will start with the ball on their own 35 after a kicking infringement, I believe.
Well,
those are always my favorite.
Yeah.
When the ref's like, I think I know what to do here, but oh no, hang on.
Correction.
Well, it was strange because it was kicked down the field. It was received at about the 10 by, I think it was Ezra Gray, and then they just blew the whistle.
And looks like it's going. Oh, you know, that's that new college rule this year. And I think Ezra Gray made a fair catch. If you fair catch the ball, then they bring it out. It used to be you bring it out to the 20, but I think they bring it out to the 35 now, if that's what the call was. It made a fair catch.
If I'm a kick returner, I'm doing that every time.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
There you go.
And that's what happens. And that rule was put in place to try to eliminate collisions.
Sure.
You know, for health reasons. But you're right. You know, hey, 35 yards, that's almost half the field.
It's fantastic field position. So here we go. Alabama State back on offense. Kadarius Davis is the quarterback. Three wide receivers for him. He'll roll out to the right. Still rolling, firing downfield, and he'll just throw it away. He had a man down there, but he was triple covered. So a smart decision by Davis, and that'll bring up 2nd and 10.
Yeah, throw it away. You live another day, you know. Live to play another down.
And the intended target was Jahad Booker, who remains out there. He's on the far side right. Near side right, Jeremy Hickson. Davis out of the gun. And the Hornets will keep it on the ground. It is Gray spinning away from a couple of defenders before finally being brought down. But there are some flags in on the play, and we'll see what the call is. Might have been a face mask.
It's going to be a face mask call. The interesting thing is that Jefferson is not in the lineup right now. You know, that's interesting. I guess we'll have to check with Rob and see if he's all right.
I see him down there. Looks like he's limping around.
Yeah,
that is a face mask. It'll be a 15-yard penalty and a fresh set of downs for Alabama State. So they get a gift there from the Tigers, and they will now move into Tiger territory. Well, rather right on midfield.
Yeah.
Almost in Tiger territory. And but, you don't want Michael Jefferson to be hurt.
Yeah, I see that he's stretching, and of course, Rob Taylor is near him. And when we go back to Rob, maybe Rob can give us a medical report on Jefferson.
Hopefully it's Michael work this time. Here's Davis flinging it out into the flat. It's Ja'Cory Merritt. He makes the catch, and he'll have a bit more. Inside the 30, down to the 25, and finally brought down at the 22.
Lanier Poet.
A 28-yard reception for Ja'Cory Merritt, and here come the Hornets.
And that's what you call a naked screen. He was out by himself. Just beat your man, and you got it made.
And there you go. Kadarius Davis throwing off his back foot again, but that has worked for him so well today. So here we go. First down. Alabama State with the ball on the 23-yard line of the Tigers. Davis out of the shotgun again. He looks right. He'll throw deep right, and
touchdown.
It's caught for an Alabama State touchdown.
Yes, sir.
And the refs will try to break up the scrum, but it's caught by number one, Jeremiah Hickson, and Alabama State is back on top, 16-13 here in the third quarter.
You know, that was a real good-looking drive by the Hornets that time, you know, and it all started with the quarterback not having what you want downfield, throw it away, and go back to the huddle and make another call, and you live another day.
And what concentration by Hickson. Had the defender right in his face.
And that's the hard part about that's somewhat of a back shoulder throw, because the receiver is facing the quarterback, and the defensive back had his back turned, and the extra point is good.
Hunter Hansen makes this a 17-13 lead now for the Hornets. And we will go to a break. Don't go anywhere, though. There's 9:32 left in the third. Alabama State now up by four. You're listening to the Alabama State football team on the Hornet Sports Network.
Tune in to the Coach's Show with Alabama State University head football coach Donald Hill Ely. Broadcasting live from Wenzel's Oyster House in downtown Montgomery and hosted by ASU Director of Athletic Strategic Communications, Travis Jerome and J.C. Coleman. Get a recap and analysis of what happened in ASU football action by tuning in to the Coach's Show, Monday evenings at 6 p.m. on FM 90.7 WVAS, the sound of excellence.
Hi, I'm Amy Goodman, host of Democracy Now! For an independent source of news and information, we bring you diverse perspectives from around the world and a deeper look at the most important events and issues that have an impact on you and your community. Join me for Democracy Now! Weeknights at 7 p.m. on the Sound of Excellence, FM 90.7 WVAS.
Campus of Alabama State University, your FM 90.7 WVAS HD, Montgomery, Alabama.
And welcome back to ASU Stadium, where the Alabama State Hornets are now up 17-13 over the Grambling State Tigers after the touchdown pass by Kadarius Davis to Jeremiah Hickson. Yeah. And they did it without Michael Jefferson, who looks maybe a little dinged up. And we're going to go down to Rob here in a moment. But Alabama State about to kick off, and then after they do, we'll go down to Rob and see if we can find out how Jefferson is doing. He was limping around a little bit on that last drive. Hansen But he'll kick it down the field, where it is taken at the 4 by number 25, Devin R. Martin. He's brought down just inside the 20. And let's go down to Rob.
All right, guys. Jefferson talked with one of the trainers, and all the trainer would say is he's going to be okay, so we expect to see him back in the game. But he was walking a little gingerly here on the sideline, and he was trotting along the sideline here, but he seems to be doing okay. Whether or not he'll get back in the game anytime soon, we'll just have to wait and see. But he seems to be coming back around for whatever was hurting him, whether it was his legs or his back, but he seems to be doing pretty good right now.
Still a really impressive touchdown. It was a 23-yard touchdown reception by Jeremiah Hickson as Grambling State goes with a running play here on first and 10, and they get a couple.
Yeah, if we could make another good defensive stop and put one more on the board, I think we're home free.
Love the SWAC.
Yes, sir.
First game in the SWAC this season for both teams, and it has been a terrific game thus far.
Yes, sir.
Second and 6 for Grambling State. Here's Hickbottom. He rolls out to his right, and he has a man, and it's number 10, Lyndon Rash, with the reception at about the 33. So that's a first down for the Tigers. And a gain of about 14 on that pass.
Bend but don't break.
They'll keep it on the ground this time. It's number 9, Raylan Richardson.
He's still going.
Still going, and finally we hear whistles. A gain of about 6 for Richardson, who actually led the team in receiving yards the last time the Tigers suited up. 63 yards on 4 catches and a touchdown against Louisiana Tech back on September 7th. Here's Hickenbottom again. Looked like he was going to take off running, but just before he reached the line of scrimmage, he winged it out to the left, and it's Lyndon Rash again, a gain of 13, and a Grambling State first down with just under 8 minutes to go here in the third quarter.
You know, that's that run-pass option where it's like a long handoff to make that play.
Grambling State continuing on with the hurry-up. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Richardson again, tumbling over midfield. A gain of about 4, and now it's 2nd and 6. And now we have a man down for Alabama State, right around the giant hornet there at midfield. And we'll see who it is. It looks like it is number 50. And that is Darius King.
Well, some scores from around the SWAC right now. We have Florida A&M is leading Southern University 17-7 in the third quarter. Mississippi Valley is trailing Bethune-Cookman 9-6. That's in the second quarter. And looking at the scores from around the SWAC, the SWAC is not doing very well in the state of Florida.
They're doing all right here in the state of Alabama.
Yes, sir.
Hornets up 17-13. And it is Richardson on the ground again. Raylan Richardson is listed as a wide receiver, but on this drive he has 3 rushes. And that one gives him a gain of a couple. So that'll bring up 3rd and 2 on the Alabama State 40, and another big play here for the Hornets defense.
You know, that's it's a great luxury to have a running back listed, a wide receiver that's playing running back, because he can be a nightmare matchup for a linebacker.
Here's Hickbottom. Here comes
holding,
the rush.
Holding.
Here come the flags. Hickbottom out to the left. He will step out of bounds, but this is going to move them 10 back regardless.
Yes, sir. There again, you know, Grambling has these big offensive linemen. When you get past them, they just grab because they're big and they're slow.
Still waiting on the call from the referee down on the field. But everybody knows what it is. So that's going to go against Carl Wilmer, the right guard out of Marksville, Louisiana. So that will push the Tigers back to midfield. And now instead of it being 3rd and 3, it's 3rd and 13.
I remember Coach Markham talking about the Grambling offensive line. He would say, they just make them so big. They just grow big.
Just how they make them down there.
Yeah.
So third and 13. It is Hickbottom. He has time. Here comes the rush. He eludes the pass rush, takes off running, but he's brought down by number 16, Nicholas Terry of the Hornets. And that'll bring up fourth down, and now it's decision time for head coach Broderick Fobbs of the Tigers, but he'll do the smart thing right here and punt it away, bringing out Miguel Mendez to boom it downfield.
Now the cards are in our hand. You know, now all we have to do now is take this kickoff, take this possession, and be methodically, beat up these last 6 minutes, and go into the fourth quarter and put it away.
Mendez really taking his time. He finally punts it. It's a beautiful one, too, down to about the two-yard line where it's fielded by a member of the Grambling State special teams, and a really good punt by Miguel Mendez, the junior out of Gonzales, California. We'll take a break. It is the Alabama State Hornets 17, the Grambling State University Tigers 13 with 5:44 to go in the third. You're listening to Alabama State Football on the Hornet Sports Network.
Tune in to FM 90.7 WVAS for Promises of God with Reverend Cromwell Handy, pastor of Dexter Avenue King Memorial Baptist Church, every Sunday at 8:45 a.m. with Angier Johnson, the gospel messenger, on FM 90.7 WVAS, the sound of excellence.
The Alabama Department of Veterans Affairs is dedicated to providing the best possible services and benefits to veterans and their families. Veteran service officers provide compensation in the VA pension claims and other veteran services in 67 counties, bringing around $1 billion in federal funds annually. We also oversee the Alabama GI Dependent Scholarship Program. The department oversees a state cemetery located in Spanish Fort. All eligible veterans receive free burial services. Go to va.alabama.gov to find out more about what we offer.
And welcome back to ASU Stadium, where the Hornets are still up 17-13 on the Grambling State University Tigers. Chris Adams-Wall with you, and JC in the booth as well. It's been a terrific game so far tonight. We've also got producer Mel Marshall here. Jay Halsey, our engineer, back in studio. Rob Taylor on the sideline. Alabama State has the ball after the punt by Miguel Mendez of the Tigers was caught at the two-yard line. So Alabama State a bit backed up right here, and they'll have to be careful. They do not want a safety. Here's the snap, and taking off up the middle, here come the flags, but Ja'Cory Merritt is all the way down to the 27, but it looks like this one is coming back.
That's probably going to come back. But, you know, it's good to see that if we lose a player, when we lose a player the caliber of a Bell, and we could put a Ja'Cory Merritt, a true freshman, in and not miss too much of a beat, I see some good things for Coach Ely's team going forward.
So that'll back them up half the distance to the goal line. So the ball is going to go on the one, and it will be first and 11.
And you got to be
for the
careful.
Hornets.
You got to be careful when you're down here, because you know your quarterback is not under center, and you can't take a chance on a bad snap or anything like that. Ball go out of bounds, you get a safety. Got to be very, very careful right here. Got to win the battle up front.
Still going out of the shotgun is Kadarius Davis. He gets the snap. He's passing. He lofts it up, and that has to be pass interference. Charged against number 21. It's not Ryan Fields, because we know he's out. Someone else apparently wearing that jersey number today. But Michael Jefferson pretty much tackled on that little fade route.
We'll take it. We got room.
So that's a spot foul, and the ball will move up to the 10. So Alabama State moves back a yard, and then they gain 9.
Yeah, we'll take it. We'll take it. We didn't get it the old-fashioned way, but we'll take it.
So first and 10 with 5:22 remaining in the third quarter. Alabama State leading 17-13 over Grambling State. It's Davis again. He'll give to Ezra Gray, who is met by the entire defensive line there for the Tigers, and he gets almost nothing. He may have, in fact, lost a yard. And that'll bring up second and 10. And let's not forget, Grambling State has won each of the last 4 meetings between these two teams. They've won 4 straight. But before that, Alabama State won 4 straight between 2011 and 2014.
So this is the tiebreaker.
There you go. It's one of those best of 9 series.
Yes, sir.
So it'll be second and 10. Davis with 1 running back to his left, and now we'll have a timeout called by Donald Ealy, head coach of Alabama State.
Yeah, we had to get a timeout that time because the play clock had ran down.
So let's go down to Rob.
Hey, guys, you see Michael Jefferson is back in the game. He doesn't appear to be 100%, but he's out there, and he's trying to make some moves and cause some distraction or whatever the coach needs him to do. He's not a quitter. Even though he's in pain, he's giving it all he's got.
Thanks, Robin. Jefferson has had a really good game today. 4 receptions for 35 yards, but no touchdowns yet, JC, and we know that he's caught at least 1 in each of his last 3 home games, so maybe that's still yet to come.
Well, you know, Rob said he's not 100%, but I'll take an 85% Jefferson on the field because, you know, you got to account for him every time he line up. So as long as he can go, we need to keep him out on the field.
His teammate Jeremiah Hickson, though, has stepped up big time. 5 receptions for 52 yards, both the receptions and the yard totals leading the team. And, of course, Hickson caught that 23-yard touchdown pass from Davis the last time the Hornets had the ball. So both teams are back out on the field with 4:36 to go here in the third quarter. It is second and 11 and more flags. And it looks like this is going to be false start on the Hornets.
You know, we got to stop moving 15 yards and then moving back 20.
This time it's on Leeward Brown, the left guard, the redshirt senior out of Miami, Florida. And that's a half the distance penalty. So that ball back on the 4. And apparently Alabama State is going to live there for the rest of this third quarter. Man,
seems like it.
Davis gets the ball out of the shotgun. He has time. He throws it over the middle, and it's complete to Tyrick Allen. He's all the way down to the 25 before he's finally tackled. And a big first down there for Alabama State. And now we'll see if they can continue to keep moving forward.
You know, Alabama State is very impressive. They've got a lot of weapons on offense.
That's a 21-yard reception by Allen. And now the Hornets will give it to the running back, Ja'Cory Merritt, who is brought down after a gain of about 2 or 3. So that'll bring up second and 8 with 4 minutes exactly remaining here in the third. Still 17-13 Alabama State.
Jefferson time.
And Jefferson is out there, but they'll keep it on the ground again to Merritt, who gets 1 or 2. And that'll bring up 3rd and 6.
And you know, Merritt has been in this whole second half, and I don't think Ezra Gray has been in the game. I don't know whether it's one of these situations where the coach is going with the hot hand, or if there's something we could be concerned about for my man Gray. So I guess Rob will have to tell us that also. Rob is the roving reporter.
Yeah, he is. With a functioning microphone.
Yes.
So here we go. 3rd and 6. Over the middle and broken up by the Grambling State defense. The intended receiver was number 8, Tyrick Allen. It's a good pass by Kadarius Davis, but lots of traffic there. And now Alabama State will be forced to punt.
And my question was answered. No, that still is Merritt. Merritt was still on the field at that time. So I guess we'll go to ask Rob when we get a chance. I don't see him on the sideline. I'm looking for number 20.
And it is number 25, Devonier Martin, back to get the punt. And here it comes from Alabama State, and it's almost blocked. This one will be fielded at about the 23, a fair catch for Booker. And Grambling State will take over.
Wow, we did a good job getting that one off. Great job getting that one off.
I don't know how he did get it off. Yeah. That was the punter, Anthony Craven.
Went through the hands of the blocker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fair catch at the 22-yard line for Martin.
So both teams will take a second to talk things over. And let's go down to Rob.
Yeah, guys, Gray, he's on the sideline. As a matter of fact, he's sitting on the bench right. I'm standing right in front of him. He seems to be okay. No injury problems or anything like that. Maybe just a little frustrated, disappointed in his play today. But I'm sure we'll see him back in this game in no time.
But now it's the Tigers, and it's the running back, Jakari Nichols, who ripped off a 55-yard run last time the Tigers had the ball. Here he goes for a gain of about five, so it's second and five on the Grambling State own 27-yard line.
And that was the same play.
Here's Hickbottom passing deep down the left side, and it's caught, but did he get a foot in? He did not. It was Quentin Geis, the senior out of Monroe, Louisiana. He did make the catch, but he was out of bounds, and nicely done there by the Alabama State secondary.
And you notice that Grambling, every time Grambling catch Alabama State with that second, I guess that second unit defensive line out there, they run hurry up. So this time, now we got a chance to get that first unit back on, and they changed their whole play call.
That was Keenan Isaac over there, the cornerback out of Midfield, Alabama, making sure that Quentin Geis did not get a foot down. Third and five now for the Tigers on their own 27 with 2:29 to go in the third. Breaking to his left is Hickbottom, and he has some room. He will have the first down. He is brought down finally. Kicked out of bounds there by number 34, Devin Booker, but a fresh set of downs for these Tigers who are now on their own 33.
You know, coaches are substituting five. He's substituting his defensive line, you know, four and five at a time. And but Graham is trying to make their move with the second squad out.
Four wide receivers, three on the right, looking right and firing right is Hickbottom. And he completes it to number 82. That's Devontae Davis, the redshirt senior out of Kaplan, Louisiana. And it's another first down for Grambling State, a gain of 11. Still 17-13, Alabama State. 1:52 to go in the third. They'll keep it on the ground this time. It is number 44, Jakari Nichols. He gets maybe one and gets the ball to their own 45.
Good stop by the Hornets.
Trips right again. Another wide out to the left. Looking left is Hickbottom, and it's a swing play to Nichols. That's a catch. He's inside the 40 before he's pushed out of bounds.
Excellent recognition by the quarterback. Defensive back had his back turned. Had he turned around, it was interception.
That was a gain of about 10 there for the Tigers. Gain of 13 officially. So they're at the 42. The Alabama State 42, more whistles. And I think a timeout has been called by Alabama State.
And Coach Pearson, Travis Pearson is livid.
Not too happy with his defense. He'll take this time to regroup, and we'll send it to break. You're listening to Alabama State Football on the Hornet Sports Network.
In America, the zip code you're born into can determine your future. If this baby was born a couple miles away, his chances of dropping out of school skyrocket. Born 5 miles farther, his chances of experiencing violent crime rise. But just one town over, his chances at a healthier life improve. At the Y, our programs help all kids thrive, no matter where they're from.
Support your local Y at ymca.net/4ofbetterus.
It can be hard to stand out from the crowd when applying for college. So consider what studying abroad with YFU can do for you. Educators agree that the benefits of high school exchange go far beyond your time abroad, and many universities give preferred admission to YFU students. Develop personal strengths while living in Germany, Thailand, Italy, or more than 40 other countries. Become a part of a host family, learn a foreign language, and test your confidence in new situations. Call 1-800-TEENAGE or visit YFUUSA.org to learn more.
And welcome back. Justin Richard, the running back for the Grambling State Tigers, has just taken a rush inside the 20. A 34-yard gain for Richard. And this ball is now on the Alabama State 18. Alabama State is leading 17-13. Out of the gun is Jeremy Hickbottom. And the give once again is to Richard, who tumbles forward for a couple. And that'll bring up 2nd and 7. Good timeout called there by Alabama State defensive coordinator Travis Pearson. Trying to give those backups a breather and get the starters back in there. So 2nd and 7, 10 seconds to go in the third. And it's a quick swing pass, and which is dropped by Quinton Geis with 5 seconds to go here in the third.
3rd and 7 for the 15.
So 3rd and 7. Will be the play, and it'll likely be the final play here in the third quarter.
If they, yeah, they're going to get it off. They're going to get the snap off. Ball has to be snapped. But I like our chances on the short field out here. I like our chances. There's not a lot of room to maneuver for Grambling.
Big play right here. It's Hickbottom. Going for a wide open man in the back corner of the end zone, and that is a touchdown to Lyndon Rash. He didn't have a defender within 10 yards of him.
Wow.
And a beautiful pass made by Jeremy Hickbottom to give Grambling State a 19-17 lead as the buzzer sounds here at the end of the third quarter.
Yeah, you just, what do you say about that play? Just busted defense all the way around. Just busted all the way around.
Just got to hope that he drops it at that point. Wow. And now it's Garrett Urban on for the extra point attempt. And he puts it through, and Grambling State now leads by 3, 20-17. That is the end of the third quarter, though. We'll go to a break. Don't go anywhere, though. This one is shaping up to be a fantastic finish. Alabama State now down by 3. You're listening to Alabama State Football on the Hornet Sports Network.
Looking to further your education? Take a look at the Harold Lloyd Murphy Graduate School here at Alabama State University. ASU graduate programs are designed to prepare students to be a part of a vanguard of professionals through the 21st century. There are several graduate programs to choose from. Doctoral programs, educational specialist programs, Master of Science programs, Master of Education programs, Master of Arts, Master of Rehabilitation Counseling, Master of Accountancy, and Master of Social Work. For more information about ASU's Graduate School, 334-229-4275 or visit alasu.edu/graduate school. Alabama State University. The time is now.
Our military service members volunteer to protect us in the most dangerous places around the world. They step up. And when they are severely ill or injured, returning to their families is only the beginning of their long road home. Wounded Warrior Project provides these brave men and women whatever they need to continue their fight for independence at no cost for life. So now it's time for a grateful nation to step up. Join us at findwwp.org.
3, 2, 1, you're back.
So Jeremy Hickbottom's 15-yard touchdown pass to a wide open Lyndon Rash has given the Grambling State Tigers a 20-17 lead now over the Alabama State Hornets as we welcome you back for the start of the fourth quarter. Chris Adams-Wall with you, J.C. Coleman, Mel Marshall, our producer back here in the booth, Jay Halsey back in studio, our engineer, and of course Rob Taylor on the sideline. Thanks so much for joining us. Game one of the SWAC play this season, and what a game it has been. But now Alabama State has to respond now that Grambling State has retaken the lead.
And I see Ezra Gray is back in the game.
He's one of the two back there to receive this kickoff. It's belted downfield by Miguel Mendez. And this one is kicked out of bounds, so Alabama State will take over on the 25 after the touchback.
Well, you know, both of these teams are showing a whole lot of character tonight. You know, they could easily say, well, you know, we gave up a big play. We're going to hold our heads down. But, you know, they're coming out and they're fighting. You know, both teams are fighting back. So the SWAC is back. That's what the SWAC is all about.
Grambling State, by the way, has 20 first downs to Alabama State's 10.
Wow.
But Alabama State has the ball now with a chance to add to their total. Man in motion to the right, and that's the guy who's getting the ball, and that's Ezra Gray. He makes the catch, and he will get, well, maybe a yard, and that'll bring up second and 9.
And you can tell the familiarity with the coaching staff is with Alabama State and Grambling. It's like Grambling is prepared when we get in motion, when they shift the defense a certain way, and Alabama State is vice versa. It's a great chess matchup. At the end of the day, it's going to come down to the 11 on the field.
And now there is a man down, apparently, right around the 30-yard line. Rob, what are you seeing down there?
That's number 4 for Grambling down on the field, and trainers are out there rubbing his legs, maybe cramps the way that they're rubbing his legs right now.
That's Damian Cromite. Is that Cromite?
Yeah, Damian Cromitty.
Cromitty.
Or Cromitai, Cromitty. We'll go with Cromitty.
Cromitty. Junior out of Tallahassee, Florida.
Yeah, 8 tackles versus Louisiana Tech, 5 of those solo. He was one of their defensive stalwarts in that game against that FBS opponent. He's back on his feet, though.
I think it's a cramp, though. It's that time. That's time of the game when cramps become, you know, kind of prevalent.
So it is 2017 Grambling State. Grambling State, who plays their home games at Eddie Robinson Stadium, named in honor of the famous Grambling State University head coach Eddie Robinson, who has the 3rd most victories in college football history, by the way. 408.
Wow.
One shy of Joe Paterno.
Wow. Coach Eddie Rob.
So here we go. 2nd and 9 for the Hornets. It's a pass to the right, and it's spiked in there by Davis. An incomplete pass attended for Jahad Booker, who had a lot of room in front of him had he made that catch, or had the pass been better, I should say.
Right. He had to go down kind of low. He actually had his knees on the ground. Had he caught the ball, you know, he couldn't advance it.
So 3rd and 9, and the ball is on the 26-yard line for Kadarius Davis and the Hornets. 3 wideouts to the left, 1 to the right, 1 running back. Dropping back is Davis. He's flushed out of the pocket. He'll take off running, scampering forward, and he'll be close to the first down. And it looks like he may have gotten it. He did get it. What a run by Davis.
That was heart and determination.
What tenacity.
Yes, sir.
Davis, the redshirt junior quarterback out of Bessemer, Alabama. Same hometown as Jameis Winston, Tampa Bay Buccaneers starting quarterback.
And Bo Jackson.
And, yeah, guy who's made a little bit more of a name for himself.
Yes, sir.
Bo Jackson. Here's Ezra Gray turning it up outside to the left, and he gets to that hash mark for a gain of about 3. That'll bring up 2nd and 7 with 13:44 to go here in the game. 2017 Grambling State.
You know, I've been watching Jefferson. I think Jefferson is being used more as a decoy. I think he's really kind of hurting.
Jefferson is up to the far side left of your screen or at the top of your screen. Here's Davis in the pocket. He'll fling it over the middle, and there is Jefferson inside the 40, and another first down for Alabama State.
So much for a decoy. You
know? Yeah, so much. I think they heard you up here, Tennessee. So that was a gain of about 20 there on that play. And now more whistles. And we'll see what the call is.
Well, I think what happened, Alabama State substituted in. Oh, actually.
What, was it too many men on the field, I believe?
Well, actually, it was too many men on the field. Alabama State did not substitute, and Grambling tried to substitute, didn't get a guy off in time.
So this ball will move up to the Grambling State 34.
And we'll take it.
First and 5, Alabama State down 20-17 with 12:44 to go here in the fourth. It's Davis. He pump fakes to his left. Now he's off to the right, and he has some room inside the 25 and out of bounds at about the 21. Great. And it's another Alabama State first down, and that offense is rolling right now.
And that's called taking what the defense gives you. You know, they had real good coverage downfield, so good recognition by Davis to tuck that ball and run. Get all you can get and get out of bounds.
And they are now officially in field goal range as well to tie this game. Alabama State, though, going for more. It's Ezra Gray up the gut this time, and he's inside the 20. A gain of about 4. And that'll bring up 2nd and 7 officially. Hunter Hansen is 1 for 2 today. Well, he has hit a long of 32.
We want to see him kick this extra point.
That's right. That's the only field goal we want right now.
Yes, sir.
Davis out of the gun again. Looking to his left, throwing it that way. It is complete to Jefferson, who stiff arms a man and then heads out of bounds. That's a gain of 8 and another Alabama State first down.
First down, Hornets.
So we told you they were going to add to that total.
Yes, sir. In the words of my grandma, we ain't done yet.
There you go. Now, they've been in this game the entire way. Yes. Both teams have. And that's what makes this fourth quarter so interesting. So many lead changes. Both teams have been seesawing. And now it's Davis handing to Gray, who takes it to about the 7 for a gain of maybe 4. And that'll bring up 2nd down and 6.
2nd and 7 from the 8.
2nd and 7 officially. Two wide receivers on the right side. Jefferson, the wide receiver, on the left. It's Davis. He's looking left. He's going for Jefferson in the back corner of the end zone. He cannot make the catch. And even if he did, I think he was out of bounds.
Yeah, I think he had him for a split second. You know, a little late to getting the ball to him that time.
So 3rd and 6 now. The red hat almost jumping out onto the field. Not yet, man. Hang on a second. Same formation. One running back, two wideouts to the right, Jefferson on the left. It's Davis. He'll go back to Jefferson, a little slant inside. He has it, but he won't get in. Does he have enough for the first down, though? That's the question. And it will be a first down.
First and goal.
And it's 1st and goal from the 1.
Yes.
What a catch by Michael Jefferson. Kind of faked the fade route, then cut inside. Davis put it right on the numbers, and Jefferson makes an impressive catch.
Jefferson is clutch. Jefferson is clutch. Now I see that coach is going back with Ja'Cory Merritt. He's had the hot hand, and Jefferson is limping off.
He is. And hopefully he's okay. He looks frustrated with himself, though.
Great job, though.
And now we'll see if Alabama State can punch it in. Davis under center for once tonight, and it is a QB sneak. A giant scrum. Has Davis gotten in yet? There is no signal. And touchdown. Now they have signal. Touchdown. And Alabama State reclaims the lead. They're now up 23-20 on the one-yard scamper by Kadarius Davis.
Impressive drive, to say the least.
Incredible. Alabama State led this game 3-0, then trailed it 7-3, then led it 10-7. Then it was tied 10-10 at the half. Grambling State then led 13-10. And now we'll see if Hunter Hansen can make it 24-20 Alabama State. He cannot. It's blocked. And that is a huge play.
Huge block.
By Grambling State. Alabama State still leads 23-20, but we are going to go down to Rob Taylor.
All right, guys. Yeah, Michael Jefferson did a great job. You can still tell he's a little shook up, probably like he got a little pain. He's talking with one of the trainers right now. They're also looking at KD right now on the sideline. Doesn't seem to be anything serious, but they are just taking a close look at him right now. Great job by the Hornets.
All right, Rob. Alabama State now up 23-20 after the block extra point. And how huge is that?
That was huge.
You think about points that Alabama State has given away. Hansen missed a field goal earlier in the game. He has that extra point blocked. Alabama State should be up right now 27-20.
And that was a critical block, because if had he made that extra point, you know, it would take a touchdown for them to take the lead. But now they could come in and, you know, they're 3 points down. You know, a touchdown can take them ahead now. But I think I got a lot of faith in our defense. Our defense has been rising up to the occasion all night long. So I think they just got to do it one more time.
And Hansen is not going to have this kickoff blocked. We know that. 23-20, Alabama State with 9:55 remaining in the contest.
Exciting football in the capital city.
First game of SWAC play, and the plot thickens. Here's the kickoff. It'll be taken from the 3-yard line by Grambling State. It is Jakari Nichols who eludes a man, heads inside, and is brought down finally at the 27. So Grambling State will now come back on offense.
We got to make one more good defensive stand. And, 9 minutes and 45 seconds left in the game.
It's a lot of time. That is a lifetime in football,
yes.
Especially at the collegiate level.
Yes.
It is starting to feel, though, I don't know if you feel this, like maybe the last team that has possession in this game wins this one.
It seems like that. That's why I'm hoping for a stop. You know, I'm praying for a stop.
We'll see if they can get it. Jeremy Hickbottom out of the gun. He has the ball. He's going for it all to the right side, and he does have a man. It is caught before he's shoved out of bounds at the 39. That was number 13, Quentin Geis. And that's a 13-yard gain and a Tiger first down. That ball now at the 39-yard line. Grambling State's own 39. 23-20, Hornets lead. Trips right for the Tigers, and it's Hickbottom again. Passing again. This time, he pump fakes to the left, going to the right now, and this time it's dropped by Geis, who is dragging across the right, and that was almost picked off by Alabama State.
That was a very, very dangerous pass.
Looked like it was number 27, Aaron Pope, who has had a big game today.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, Alabama State's starting strong safety, Joshua Hill, was ejected from the game on the first offensive play by Grambling State for targeting tonight. Here's a completion to the left side, and over the 50 and down to the 45 goes number 86 for Grambling State, and that's DeQuarius Thomas out of Alexandria, Louisiana. So another first down with under 9 minutes to go. Here's a rushing play. And it is number 27, Justin Richard, who gets one, maybe two.
You know, Alabama State actually plays better defense on a short field than playing on this wide open field.
There's a man down for Alabama State. Looks like number 16, Nicholas Terry, one of the Hornets linebackers. What a game, though. 8:29 to go. We'll take a break. You're listening to the Alabama State football team on the Hornet Sports Network.
Hey, man, missed you at the party. What's up?
My ex-girl keeps texting and following me around. There she is now.
You said we would be together forever.
It's over. You need to stop stalking me.
Stalking is not cute. It's a crime just like domestic and sexual violence.
We're students representing ASU,
Huntington,
Tuskegee, and Troy.
If you're victimized or if you see something, say something.
No matter where you go, you're going to get help.
For more info, call 334-229-6767, 24/7.
I wasn't prepared to be a caregiver to Mom. I had no idea how hard it would be and what I would need to know. Things I never thought of, like how to improve her mood and ways for me to stay positive. Luckily, I found the Caregiving Resource Center from AARP. It had articles about the basics, but also information about the hurdles I was facing. Caregiving Resource Center at aarp.org/caregiving. Articles, tips, and tools to help you both care for your loved one and care for yourself. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
Pass complete to Geis. Grambling first down. He's running out of the 28-yard line.
So Quentin Geis just made a big reception on the last play for Grambling State. He is down to the 28. Another first down for the Tigers. Alabama State is up 23-20 with just over 8 minutes remaining in the game. Here's Hickbottom, who will hand it off to Jakari Nichols. He'll take it up the gut, and he's down to about the 22.
Good for 8 yards, second and two from the 20.
And that's a gain of 8, second and two.
That's the same play he broke for a big gain early on in the game.
And back into the game comes Christian Clark.
Yes, sir.
Who led the team with 11 tackles last week against Kennesaw State, including 5 of them solo. It's Hickbottom, the gift to Nichols again, and he is going nowhere.
And Clark lost his helmet, so he's got to sit out one play.
Austin Brundage, though, was in on the play. The redshirt sophomore out of Birmingham, Alabama, sniffed out the run up the middle. And that'll bring up 3rd and 4, and if Alabama State can stop them right here, that might bring out the field goal unit to try to tie this game.
That'll be interesting.
3rd and 4. Passes out to the left, and it's Geis. He has it. He cuts inside. Did he get enough for the first down, though? That is the question. It looked like he did. Got just enough. And now Geis needs to come out. He needs a breather. So into the game comes Donald Johnson, Jr. 1st and 10 on the Alabama State 17 with 7:20 remaining in the game. Alabama State leading 23-20. It's Hickbottom again. He gives it to Jakari Nichols, who breaks out to the left. He's brought down at about the 15, so a gain of 2.
That was a good tackle that time because he had daylight ahead of him.
2nd and 7 officially. 3 wide receivers on the right, 1 on the left. Runner in the backfield is Nichols. The throw is to the right. And it is caught, though short of the first down. And it is number 86 again. And that is DeQuarius Thomas, the redshirt senior. So a gain of just 3 and 3rd and 4 again, JC.
Had a good tackle that time by Darius King. You know, he's one-on-one. He caught the ball, but he couldn't advance it. So
can the Alabama State defense get a stop? 3rd and 4, Hickbottom looking left. Here comes the pressure. Now he looks right, fires to the end zone, and it was very nearly picked off by the quarterback, Keenan Isaac. He was looking for, I think, number 10, Lyndon Rash again, but Isaac all over it, and now the Tigers will bring on their kicker, Garrett Urban, to try to tie this game with a field goal.
Yeah, this is going to be... It should be a chip shot, but, you know, chip shots are not automatic.
He is 2 for 3 today. This is going to be about a 23-yard field goal. Here's the kick. It's on the way, and it is
no good.
Wide left. And the Hornets take over. As Garrett Urban misses his 2nd field goal of the night. And we will go to a break. Don't go anywhere, though. Alabama State now has the ball. They're up 23-20. You're listening to the Alabama State football team on the Hornets Sports Network.
My grandfather served in World War II. Spending time with him were the best memories of my life. I became a physician at VA because of my grandfather, so I can help others like him. I can't imagine working with better doctors or a more dedicated staff. I'm fulfilling my life's mission with the help of my team and thanks to these veterans. I'm proud to be a doctor at VA and proud to honor my grandfather every day. Search VA Careers to find out more.
Introducing a new day of the week. Someday. Now, everything you were going to do someday is on the calendar. Want to retire someday? You'll really want this. A My Social Security account at socialsecurity.gov. You can estimate your future benefits and manage current benefits online. Millions of people have a My Social Security account. Get yours today, because someday is here at socialsecurity.gov.
Three, two, one, you're back. And welcome back to ASU Stadium in downtown Montgomery, Alabama, where Garrett Urban has just missed a potentially game-tying field goal. It is still 23-20 Alabama State. But let's go down to Rob Taylor on the sideline.
Wouldn't it be great, guys, if Grambling never touched the football again within these 6 minutes and 7 seconds? That would just do it for the Hornets right there. But that was great defense by the Hornets. They played it tough. They could have, you know, laid down and just gave up, but they hung in there, played it tough, and they got the job done. Well, a little help from the Lord, of course.
We'll see how they do. 6 minutes and 7 seconds to go, and it is Kadarius Davis keeping on a sweep out to the left. He'll be brought down after a gain of about two. That'll bring up second and eight on their own 22.
Yeah, it's going to be real critical that we get at least two first downs. You know, let's get the first one first. And we can get two first downs, and we can almost lock this thing away. Take care of the ball.
Grambling State still has 24 first downs to Alabama State's 15, but so far that has not mattered. Alabama State up by three. Second and eight with 5:30 to go in the game. It is Davis over the middle, and it's completed to Javon Booker. Booker all the way over to the right side. He is brought down, and he's over the 30 to the 32 for a first down.
That was actually Jefferson.
No, Jefferson, I beg your pardon. Yeah, see, it's about time for me to get glasses.
Well, no, you know, because he's actually been sandbagging. We thought he was hurt.
Unbelievable.
Yes.
Michael Jefferson still out there on the far side left with under 5 minutes to go. First and 10 for the Hornets. It's Davis out of the shotgun. And right now, I think Alabama State wants to bleed a little bit more clock. Play clock down to four now, three. Here's the snap. And it is Ezra Gray. Look at him tearing at his jersey. Still not down. Finally, he goes down. But it's after a gain of about two. So second and eight as we approach 8 o'clock here in the Capital City.
Yeah, Grambling's defensive lineman, Wesley Green, lost his helmet that time. So he's got to sit out of play.
And we know what this series has been like for both teams over the last 4 years. It's been all Grambling State. Remember, Alabama State didn't even score in this game last year, losing 34 to nothing. Right now, they're winning 23-20.
1 o'clock run.
4:10 to go in the game. Play clock at 15, and no need to hurry if you're the Hornets. Davis is out of the shotgun. He has a man next to him. That's Ezra Gray. Two wide receivers on the left, another on the right. The give is to Gray. He takes it up the middle, and he got through the first tackler and scampers forward for a gain of six and a huge third and one coming up for these Hornets with 3:42 to go in the game.
Yeah, the Hornets are doing a good job now of bleeding that play clock, letting it run all the way down to two and three seconds and taking a snap. And another first down. Be pretty good.
This is the 42nd meeting in a series that dates back to 1979. Grambling State holds the all-time edge at 28-13. So Alabama State does not win these games all that often, but they are ever so close to doing so here tonight. Third and one. They give it to Gray, and he does have the first down up the middle as he almost takes it to midfield. And how big a first down is that going to be?
And that first down was huge. That's a huge first down because it gives you another set of downs, and Grambling had to call timeout.
Timeout, Grambling, with 2 minutes and 53 seconds remaining in the game, your score.
Let's send it down to Rob Taylor.
Oh, God, this is just exciting football right here. And we just watched the coaches run out on the field and talk to the ASU players during this timeout. If we could just continue to hold on to the ball, it would be great. Just continue to hold on to the ball, pick up those first downs, let that clock run. They're doing a great job, as you said, JC, of utilizing the clock, letting it run down before they snap the football. This is great football right here.
SWAC is back, as you say, JC.
Well, you know, and if Alabama State continue to hold on and win this game, this will be our first SWAC opener since 2014 that we won the game.
Wow.
So this game has huge implications all the way around.
And remember, after this week, Alabama State will have a bye. They will not play again until October 5th at home against Alcorn State, the team that won the 2018 SWAC championship. On the other side, Grambling State, they will have their first home game of the year next week on September 28th against Prairie View A&M. So here we go, first and 10 for the Hornets on their own 49. 3:03 to go in the game, and it is a run up the middle. Looks like Ja'Cory Merritt, but he's not going anywhere.
He's definitely protecting that football, and I'm pretty sure the coaches told them during that timeout, protect the football, because Grambling is trying to strip the ball now.
The clock continues to run. Down to 2:40 now. And a lot of standing around. And, of course, 20 seconds left on the play clock. This is what the Atlanta Falcons should have done a couple of years ago in the Super Bowl, right?
Yeah.
Up 28-3 in the third quarter.
Yeah, still lost the game.
Could have ended better for them.
Well, it is Atlanta.
Davis will get the snap out of the shotgun, and they'll keep it on the ground, will Alabama State. And that runner is swallowed up. It's Ja'Cory Merritt again. He does get a gain of one. So now it's 3rd and 9 with 2:12 to go, and Grambling State will take their second timeout.
And Grambling has one timeout.
Yeah, I was going to say, I thought that was their final timeout.
Oh, that's their final timeout.
Yeah.
Okay. Now all the Hornets have to do now is get a first down. You get a first down, now you can go in.
Then you can wrap it up.
Yeah, you can go in victory mode.
But 3rd and 9... Those are going to be the longest 9 yards they've gone all game.
And it's going to be the most important 9 yards they've gone.
Can Alabama State hang on? We told you about all the lead changes, though, today.
Yeah, it was back and forth. It was actually a good game. You know, both ways, Alabama State made some mistakes. Grambling made some mistakes. At the end of the day, it comes down to who capitalized on the mistakes the best.
Alabama State struck first. They were up 3-0, then they were down 7-3, then they were down 10-7, then it was 10-10 at the half, then it was 13-10 in favor of Grambling State, then Alabama State went up 17-13, Grambling then went up 20-17, and now the Hornets are up 23-20. They're back on the field for this critical 3rd and 9. It's Davis out of the gun. He has some time. Here comes the rush, though. He loses his helmet, and there is a penalty flag.
15 yards.
And that might do it for the Hornets. Davis lost his helmet, and, of course, it was ripped off by a defender for Grambling State, and it looked like it was number 8, Anthony Mullins, who did the deed.
And that's going to be a huge one. That's automatic first down, 15 yards. Yes. Well, that's just going to do it for Grambling.
And Mullins is incredulous after that one. He's saying, what did I do wrong? Well, you took his helmet off. And Alabama State will probably be able to just put this one away right now.
Yeah, we could go in victory formation because Grambling has no timeouts. Grambling cannot stop the clock. So we've got to snap the first one.
They got a 25-second play clock, though, so they might get it back with, oh, I don't know, about 10 seconds or so. Under 2 minutes to go, though, in this one. And if you're Alabama State, if you do, in fact, run it, you got to hang on to that pigskin.
Hang on to the ball.
The give is to Gray. He'll take it to the right side, and he's met by a horde of Tigers. He's going nowhere, but he secures the football, and the clock keeps running.
The clock is running, and the clock is Grambling's worst friend right now, biggest enemy.
So that'll bring up second and 11. 23 on the play clock, 1:15 to go in the game.
Oh, we can go in victory formation now.
And they are going to do the victory formation.
Yes. Well, as an opposing team, well, you hate the knee. You hate it right here.
Still think they'll have a chance of getting the ball back, no?
No, they can't stop the clock. Cannot stop it.
Davis will take the knee. And now, right, now there's 40 seconds left on the play clock. Alabama State is going to win this game for the first time since 2014. They will snap that four-game losing skid to one of the most historically competitive programs in the country, Grambling State. And what a win.
This is a great victory, and, you know, it's good going into a bye week before you take on the East. You know, you're playing the West Division champions from last year, and your next SWAC game will be against the East Division champions, Alcorn State. And it's great right now to have this victory under your belt. And wow, I'm excited. I want to go down on the field.
Alabama State wins 23-20. They improve to 2-2 on the year and 1-0 in the SWAC. Grambling State falls to 0-3 overall there, 0-1 in the SWAC. And how about these Hornets? A huge win for them. And let's send it down to Rob, who's down there with the winning team.
All right, guys, you know how Coach Ely does. He wants to get all his players off the field and show some sportsmanship. Allow the guys to shake hands, make sure there are no problems, and he'll get the guys to come together, and most likely the guys will make their way over to the band here and sing the school alma mater before heading into the locker room. What a game. And the Hornets held on to the football for the last 6 minutes and 7 seconds. That was a fantastic job by the offensive unit. Coach Joe Blackwell and his offensive unit did a great job there.